Hello, hello, hello everyone. Welcome. Yes, we are 2 minutes before time and the games are about to begin. Today we have a tie break day, so that is going to be extremely exciting. Vidit, Gukesh and Padmini are in the tie breaks. Let us see the opponents. One second there. Yes. Gukesh will be playing with Daniel Dubov. Oops. Hello, hello,
Hello,
hello.
hi
Thanks
everyone.
for joining.
What a day we are going to witness today.
Yeah. We have a
Because
guest, by the way. Sagar Shah, welcome.
thank you. So, Vidit Gujarati takes on, who is he taking on? Alexander Pierre from Brazil, 2569. Gukesh takes on Daniel Dubov. And these are some of the very interesting things. We have three Indians. Padmini takes on Sara Sadat. So Vidit versus Alexander Fier, Gukesh versus Daniel Dubov, and Padmini versus Sara Sadat. So the format of this tie break is the following: that if it is 25 minutes plus 10 seconds increment and two games, if it ends in a draw, we go to 10 minutes plus 10 second increment. If it again ends in a draw 1-1, then we go to 5 minutes plus 3 second increment. If they again end in a draw 1-1, then we go into the Armageddon with 5 minutes to white, 4 minutes for black. That is how things are going to be. And Amruta, what are your thoughts on the matches? Who do you think are the favorites?
I think Vidit is the favorite in Vidit versus Fear. Also, Padmini is the favorite. Gukesh has the toughest opponent as we know, but
Padmini,
yesterday.
you would say Padmini is the favorite in spite of Sara Khadem being rated
Yes.
almost 124 Elo points.
Right.
Okay, the games have begun, so let's get it going. Vidit playing with the white pieces opens the game. Oh, sorry, with the black pieces. E4, Amruta, E5, Knight F3, Knight C6, and he's played for the Berlin
Berlin, right?
castles. And will he take the pawn? I think he should take the pawn. Guys, 25 minutes plus 10 seconds increment. He's taken the pawn. Hello to everyone in the chat. What are they saying, Amruta?
They are saying close to 716K chat. OP, they are saying go VD, Berlin, VD hearts, Catalan and Gukesh's board. Yeah, all that.
Oh, by the way, look at Alexander Fier's opening, Amruta. He's gone rook e1, which is not very combative. It's around equal. You can take the knight. You can also play castles. So in this, I think Vidit has this strategy clear. Yeah, hold
Yeah,
with black,
exactly.
attack with white.
I think it's a good strategy for tactics.
Yes, and Vidit is a very classical player, so he likes to play this way. Many people, you know, they play complicated openings from both white and black, but
Correct.
Vidit prefers to play solidly with black many times, if not required.
But also his opponent, yeah, Fear is a very a player who loves complicated positions. So that's the reason I think with black, such a decision is very practical.
Yeah, so we have the live board here that is going on, and Amruta, let me put this up here so that all three players are seen. And also, let's go to Gukesh's game because Gukesh is playing with the black pieces against Dubov, and the game starts off with d4, knight f6, c4, e6. We have the Catalan on the board, bishop g2, castles, castles, open variation. Queen c2, a6, a4. This happened yesterday as well. And I guess Gukesh is better prepared today. A5 he played because remember yesterday Dubov was able to play a5 and then Gukesh had gone b5 and then ab6, cb6 had happened. So
Now you
a5,
say that.
rook fd1, h6, take, take, knight to e5, all preparation for Dubov. He's on 27 minutes on the clock.
Oh, so bishop g2, king g2, was that like, can this be the
Yeah, bishop
continuation?
g2, king g2, c6 might well be what we will witness on the board. And it seems like Dubov is well prepared. He trusts this position. Let's quickly check what Padmini is doing.
Sure.
Padmini Raut playing with the white
And we have a
pieces.
new member, Devin Tiwari, 2000. Welcome to the backer of Indian Chess. You're the first member for today's stream, so thank
Thank
you.
you, Devin. And Amruta, this is the opening that was
Scotch
played
Gambit,
yesterday
right?
as well, the Scotch Gambit, Bishop
Very
D7.
surprising, right? Actually, in tie breaks, rapid game, they are repeating the opening.
Yes, Queen B8 was played yesterday as well,
B3, this is
B3.
also we are following up.
Maybe
Maybe
yesterday
queen.
she went
No, knight.
C3, I believe. Today, Queen D3, A5. And now Padmini is thinking for her move. Sara seems to be well prepared. Guys, let's have some thoughts in the chat as to who do you think
Exactly.
will win between Vidit and Alexander Fear here? Who will win the match? And if you think it's Vidit, let's go for E4 in the chat. If you think it's Fear, then let's go for E5. So just E4, E5. If you think it's Vidit, let us know.
Yeah,
And
VD, 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 VD. Sujit Varghese, welcome. How are you?
wow, look at this, Amruta. Look at this. I have never seen such a one-sided poll. No E5 to be seen. Almost for a few seconds, there was only E4. 160 people. There's like nearly 95% of the people think Vidit will win this, and that is.
Amazing, amazing belief, guys. Come on, get going. Let's
Also, there are a
check the
few
game.
people who think now that Fear would win this, so very interesting. And let's do it for the others. Well, I'm very interested to see, guys, for
Yeah.
Gukesh and for Dubov. E4 for Gukesh, E5 for Dubov. What do you think?
But do we not have to clear the moves?
Yes, we will.
Ah.
E4, E5. E4 for Gukesh, D4 for Dubov. Sorry, E5 for Dubov.
And while the poll is going on, Abhishek Mari, welcome to the backer of Indian chess. You are the second member for today.
Yeah. Thank
Thank
you,
you, thank
Abhishek.
you.
Vidit has gone Queen E7, and let's have a look at what Gukesh people think. Wow, they think Gukesh will win. Amruta, so many
Oh.
people think Gukesh will
And the
win against
majority is
Dubov.
pretty high, like 70%. That's
Guys, I have a
amazing.
feeling that today Gukesh will give a tough fight to Dubov. Beating him will be very difficult because he's a world-class player,
Yes,
and
but
Gukesh will need tremendous nerves to beat him. But you think he'll win?
yes,
Okay,
I
we'll see,
think.
we'll see. And we'll do Padmini's vote as well in a bit. But first, just a small explanation of what's happening here in Vidit's game. Vidit castled d4, bishop f6, rook e1, rook e8. He played b6. They exchanged on e1, queen e7, knight a3, and bishop b7. So you can feel that in this position, White is very slightly better, Amruta, because let's say I take, it's a very concrete move now. Bishop takes d6, bishop takes d6, and guys, what should White play in this position? Let us know your thoughts in the chat. There is a very strong move for White, which gives him an advantage here. What do you
Wow,
think?
that's a tough question down there then.
Yeah. And if Fear is able to play
Knight.
it, then Vidit would be in some trouble.
Hello Joy, hello, 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 go India.
Thank you, Joy. Thank you so much for your super chat and for following. Yes, we have the correct move that is flowing in actually.
No, ah, second one, right?
Third
Exactly,
one.
third one now. Dominic, Olivia, Om Gada, Aryan, Hemant, chess patcher. Oops, it's tough for you, right, Sagar? Because there is a race between knight b5 and knight c4. Dutta, Nidukala, Om Gupta, Varun, Prakash, Aryan Ranjan.
Thank you and congratulations to all of you because the move is so cool now. Amruta, knight
Right.
b5 hits the bishop, also the pawn here. And
You
if you
have to go
move the
bishop
bishop,
f4.
then you will lose this. If you go bishop f4, I can attack
g3.
you with g3. So it looks not so great. Like, for example, if I go bishop f4, g3, I push you away with a6, trying to win here. Then after gf4, ab5,
bishop
b5, and bishop b5, anyway, white wins a pawn. So,
a lot of you had said rook e1 there, but rook e1, you can just stop with the e6 the next time.
You mean here?
No, bishop d6, like when you had asked the question. No, knight
yes,
c4
rook
and
e1.
For rook e1, you can just go
in. No, even you can just take this, spoil the structure, and then maybe king f8. Next move, you can go rook e8 or bd5.
Right.
So,
and for knight c4, you can just move the bishop instead of rook e1. So that would be fine.
I don't know what Vidit did wrong, because Fear has done this, and now Vidit is, I think, going to be under some pressure. Although I don't think his position is losing after knight b5. Let's say even if I play a move like king f8, just for the sake of argument.
Yeah.
Knight takes d6, c takes d6. The structure is slightly uncomfortable, and I'm not sure, like f3.
But would you call
king
these
f2?
Double pawns, what to say, anything which is being a hindrance? Because I don't see that as of now. Yes, d5 cannot be pushed because your b7 will become really bad. But what if I keep the structure as it is? Maximum is you get some space, right?
Yes, I mean, it just landed in a slightly inferior position. But you are right that white is not winning or anything. But for sure that something went wrong. Like, for example, here, maybe not queen e7.
Queen f8.
But maybe, first knight e8, then bishop b7, going a little slow. I think Vidit hurried a bit with queen e7. And that's where this has happened. And he is now thinking, taking his time. Let's go quickly with Gukesh. What is he doing? We had seen until knight e5. He took on g2, king g2, played his pawn to c6, as you mentioned. e3, bishop d6, queen e2, and now queen e7. Knight went back to c4, and Gukesh said, I've got my chance to push the pawn to e5, and he's pushed it.
I thought he will save his bishop to c7.
Yeah,
because
exactly.
It stops knight b6 also. Any ideas? And I'm going to get e5 in the future, right?
Yeah, I mean, you generally go rook f8, maybe knight d7, e5. But Gukesh has been very direct. He's played e5. And Amruta, I think that after d5, here maybe if you take knight takes, rook takes, this is a dream position for white. Because the bishop is quite bad, and I'm going rook d1 or rook c1, a5 can be weak, b6 square is weak.
Yeah,
so
I mean,
all...
if black could have got e4, then it's fine. But right now d6 is hanging, and when you go bishop c7, most probably white will go e4 or no?
Yeah, I don't
it
think
even
e4
matter.
Does matter so much. It's just that the white pieces are very active,
yes.
So Gukesh, after d5 was played, has played bishop b4. This was his point.
Oh, so
his
he was
point
prepared
was...
for this move d5. He played very quickly bishop.
So if you now take, he wants to take on c3. You cannot
right.
take here,
why?
Amruta.
Why?
This is a blunder, because I take with a check to the king. So then you will be a piece down. And so b takes c3. And after this, maybe b takes c6. Okay, white might be slightly better because this is a weaker pawn than the a4 pawn. The knight is well placed, but not
this,
much.
I think for Gukesh to defend, this is a much easier position than what we've seen.
Yesterday we saw how Gukesh defended like a lion against Dubov. So this might not be so difficult for him to defend as well. What's up with Padmini? So Padmini, after queen b6, queen d3, a5, she played knight d2. Sara said, I'm capturing, takes, take on d4.
So they
and
have
now,
landed in opposite colored bishop like yesterday.
Yes. And Padmini went bishop b2. But I think, Amruta, bishop f2 would also have been pretty strong, because what are you going to do against queen c3?
Oh, the typical when you go for c5, right?
Yeah.
Queen c3 idea. So d4, if
let's say
if
you
goes,
castle, then this is hanging. And so you
d4.
Try to defend, let's say d4. Then I go c3, and already your structure
too fast.
Is in...
You're too fast, Sagar. Very, yeah, this is very good. So is it the same happening by bishop b2, where she's maybe stopping black's castle? Let's say castle, a move like a natural, should be a problem because of e6?
No, d5 is hanging, first of all.
Okay,
so
let's say d4 now. Then you go c3,
anyway,
and do
c3.
You have the same advantage?
Well, what has happened here, Amruta, is that Padmini's king is safer than the black king. Because even if Let's say I go bishop c6, trying to defend here, f5, and you really don't want to be castling here because f6 is game over.
Queen and
Khalas. Khalas, this is over because queen g5, g6, queen h6 is over.
Absolutely.
So Padmini with this opposite color bishop definitely has some attacking prospects in the position. We will see how Sara defends, but maybe bishop f2 was even better. Bishop b2 is an aggressive move, true to Padmini's style. She loves to attack. She's put the bishop there. Okay, coming back to Vidit's game, after knight takes b5, Vidit has decided he went bishop c6, knight d6 and cd6. This is not a happy choice for you because, you know, okay, it's happened. Now you face it. But I also feel Amruta Vidit would be thinking that in the end, let's say if he goes rook e1 here,
f8.
King f8, f3, trying to bring the king. I'll go rook e8, rook takes e8, king takes e8. This should be a draw.
Yeah, because now maybe you get your king ahead and you can even go d5. I don't think it would be a big problem.
So yeah.
I think it's easy to defend.
Yeah, this should be defendable. I think Vidit's aim should be to hold here, not try for... I mean, to try for something is, of course, not very possible with this limited material. But fear now taking time, you know, fear might be trying for some ideas. Say, for example, Amruta, I could start thinking about f3, king f2, maybe get my rook to d1, think of pushing you with d5. There are some plans for white. Let's see how well fear can push. If Vidit can get an easy draw here, then he would definitely be pumped up for his white game.
True.
Okay, going back to Gukesh's game, after e4 has been played in this position.
So he didn't take on c6 like we were thinking as an option.
Yeah.
e4 is maybe stronger. Keeps the contention, I mean. But it also gives a hook. I don't know. Sagar, do you ever want to consider a plan like moving your knight and going f5, or is that out of question?
I think there is too much tension in the center to play a move like f5, because you see the rook in the center. This is a potential passed pawn.
So first rook d8, maybe I'll go for.
I think rook fd8 may be better somehow.
So I think the two rooks are fighting. Yeah, both of them want to come to d8.
I don't know, somehow I feel that if you take here, then this rook may be needed to defend a5.
Correct.
So I would play my fd8.
So if your plan in the future is to take the knight, then you might take the rook fd8. And if your plan is to retain that bishop on b4, then you want to go rook d8, because after f5 also f2, you know, bishop.
Amruta
c5.
Is very keen on playing f5, although I don't think that's going to happen, Amruta. Okay. Because where do you get your knight out? Here? Knight at 7,
Can I ask you a question? Can you just try, if there is something like a big problem in rook d8? I think there can be.
No, I mean, it's completely fine.
It is also playable.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's say rook c1. And then if you try knight d7, this is a problem, I believe. Because now it's somehow just, I mean, it's I can go knight a2, attack your bishop. Then d6 could be an idea. So maybe not. Okay, let's go to Padmini's game. After bishop b2, her opponent has played d4 here.
So Padmini should play c3 or f5. No, f5 you had mentioned, right?
No, castle I had mentioned f5. F5.
Castle for d4 or c3 is possible.
Yes,
or
c3
f5.
Is one move. King h1 looks a natural human move.
No, but because... king h1, I would say it's a little slow. Like when you have options like f5.
No, I'm just a bit... let's say c3 and you go c4. Yeah, but then I have cd4. So there is no problem here, right?
So one more question. c3 is possible. Okay. Yeah. What about f5 if you start right now?
Yeah, I think Padmini is also thinking between these two moves. Maybe Sara can just long castle, which is actually a tough move to think of. But then you are saying that my king is definitely safer here. Then on g8.
Yeah, I think that would be okay if Sara is prepared and knows these ideas, maybe, but otherwise long castle would be impossible to imagine.
Oh well,
right?
Maybe not impossible. Once you realize that castle is just lost after f6, then your mind will be like, I need to do something, and you long castle.
Like, I can't keep my king in the center, I can't castle, so the only option remains is long castle.
for now, Padmini is thinking whether she should go c3, which is a nice positional move, or she should go aggressive with f5.
So even if Padmini sees that white can castle, black can long castle, she may avoid f5 and she will go c3 because c3 is not giving you the time to long castle.
Right.
So let's see what happens.
Okay, here a4 had been played by Fear, and now after a4, a5 was played, f3, g6, king f2, king g7, bishop c4. And
d5. He might think of d5 here. So the question is whether you want to allow white's d5 or whether you want to play d5 yourself. Okay, allowing d5 will give white more space, and king e3, king d4 can be an option. I don't think it's a bad move to go for d5.
Yes.
What do you think?
Yeah, I think Vidit will soon build a fortress.
Yeah,
he will stop thinking about what are his activity for his bishop. It will more be revolving around how will white try to break in.
Right.
And I think there's no easy way to do it.
I think so.
So maybe b4 could be an idea. But then if Vidit just stands steady, like let's say d6 and waits, it might not be easy for Fear to break through. Also because the a4 pawn is a weakness.
No, the only thing is bishop b5 can be very strong for white. Because if you take there, then your a5
yeah,
is...
Yeah, but I have rook c8 and I'll put pressure here.
Yeah. So imagine if white's king was on d3 already. Yeah. So Vidit will have to be slightly careful.
But you know, he's cutting his king. So...
Acha, it's not easy.
Vidit has good defensive resources here. Okay, going back to Dubov versus Gukesh. This is a long thing by Gukesh. Amruta, he's down to 13 minutes.
So 10 minutes
He's already taken 7 minutes for this move.
You know, Sagar, this is a little critical. What he's doing is finding a plan. So it's about which pieces, where you want them to be placed. And I don't think he may have to think so long in the upcoming moves because it will be clear.
Yeah, but to think for so much time, maybe not a great...
Hi Sagar, I've been improving at Blitz but still really bad at slow games. What to do? Also, can you do a 1 hour coaching for me? I will pay, of course, for your coaching.
The general idea is why you do not improve longer time controls, right? That was his question.
Yeah.
Is because sometimes you are not calculating well enough. So maybe slow and steady with Biswa, this would be very useful for you, or the imbalance theory, or the improving chess with Sagar Shah. Could be a good idea to check.
Also, slower games you might still try to be very tricky and trappy, thinking and underestimating your opponent basically. So if you're doing that doesn't work always.
Yeah. And for the training part, I think there's so much material on Chess Base India. I don't think you need to spend for training with me, so that's just available there for free. Okay, Amruta, she has gone rook ae1. Oh, by the way, look at this.
Oh, she did long castle.
No, she went f5. She went f5.
Okay.
Opponent did long castle. Sarah did long castle. And now rook ae1. Wow, this game is really
very
intense.
Interesting.
Now this pawn is weak. You can go c3. But also the bishop here coming to c6 or b5. I mean, black is just saying that my king is safe here.
Hmm.
And Padmini says, okay, fine, your king, I don't care. I want to maybe create a passer.
Yeah, also the king is, sorry, but not very safe there.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be...
I know it's not safe, but it's not easy to break through. You know, how do you open it up? For example, you can go c3.
If I go c3, let's try that.
Well, let's say first I go rook h8, stopping some e6 ideas. You go c3, correct?
But e6 was not happening, right? Takes, bishop e6 is already there.
I mean, just as a useful move.
Okay.
And then you go maybe bishop c6. And how do we continue here? For example, cd. What is happening, Amruta? You see, this d-pawn is such a big distraction that you are not able to mount an attack easily.
I think that bishop on b2... is something now that I don't like it there.
Yeah, the bishop would be better placed here for sure. But this is great understanding by Sara Khadem. You can say she is a top player from Iran and she has understood that I can castle long. somehow the ratings have been interchanged, guys. In this,
exactly.
Sara is 2494 and Padmini is 2370. But, well, you know this already. You have been following this.
But she did play Rook H8.
She did go Rook H8, yeah. Okay, now Vidit's game has moved ahead a bit. Bishop to c4, d5, bishop d3 happened, Amruta, and now Vidit played f5.
Really, I was considering that maybe an idea to put all the pawns on light squares, threatening to play f4 and g5, so white will have to go f4. And then you kind of block the position. There is no break that way you defend.
Oh, rehta na, like you, like there is a, like, enemy going to come and you just close all your doors and you just sit tight with the gun inside and you're like, if you come, I'll shoot you. But otherwise, and I think this is one position where Vidit is confident in his defensive resources. Generally, it's not a good idea to put your pawns on the same color as the bishop. But here, this bishop already attacks this pawn.
Exactly.
I think he should be able to hold it. Like,
also, the only one pawn has been exchanged, because of which there is not much entry for white's king to easily king or even rook to easily attack the weaknesses. And for that, he will have to create another break, which is b4, the only break. But you can see Vidit has kept his rook and bishop very well placed. White will have to go bishop c2 and then try for b4. But then you might get beat by yourself.
I think he shouldn't play b4 instantly. Maybe b3 with the idea of c4. So white has many plans. It all depends on fears.
Fearless.
Hunger for victory here, or you know how much he wants to grind.
Yeah.
But it's not easy for sure.
Yeah. Raghav Malviya says, please analyze great games from 2008 World Championship.
Okay, Raghav, that's interesting suggestion.
We have a huge super chat by Akshay Gupta.
Akshay, thank you so much.
$79.99.
Australian dollars.
Australian dollars.
Great work, guys. Thank you, Akshay, for your very huge super chat. Very kind of you. Thank you.
And Kishore Hazarika has become a member. Welcome to the pillar of Indian chess.
Kishore Hazarika used
to
send...
He must have liked your t-shirt, I think.
Yeah, today's t-shirt is not great. But Kishore Hazarika always has supported chess since a long time. So thank you so much, Kishore.
I thought you will say it always supported your t-shirts.
Yeah. Okay. So Gukesh's game, he went queen c5. And Dubo has played his rook a to c1 almost without taking time. And now Gukesh has almost a 12 minute deficit on the clock.
But queen c5 is something which I don't understand, because when rook is on c1, you already feel some discomfort where discovered attacks might be in the air. So why queen c5? What would he be thinking? What do you think, Sagar?
I think he might want to take on d5, but then of course knight d5 and e d5 or even rook d5 gives white very good position.
No, so maybe he wants to take on c3 and then win the pawn on d5. But
yeah, but then I take with very... the rook, and now there are some discovered ideas.
So if you take cd5 here, he will go knight e5 maybe, or first
knight e5 and then next move ed5. And so Gukesh has some thinking to do. He has taken on c3, rook c3 has happened, but now Dubo is clearly pushing here. This is the pawn, guys. This is the pawn which is very strong. Also, notice knight takes e5 is hanging. So what is on Gukesh's mind? Maybe, Amruta,
CD5,
like always,
I think, because otherwise the whole idea of queen c5 bishop takes doesn't make sense.
And now if ed5 is played, then now knight d5 is a free pawn.
Ah, because you are attacking the rook, so there is no discovered attack.
Yes, and if you play queen e5 here, I can still just save my rook ad8, and it seems like black is okay.
Ooh, because there are ideas of after rook ad8,
knight
let's
say I go knight
four.
e3.
Knight e3 is another.
Then there is check.
Ooh, but your queen is also hanging, no?
Yeah, but there's a check, no? So knight e3 can't play. But if I go knight a3, just attacking this, then once again there is a very powerful move here. Guys, white to play, black to play. What do you do here? Black to move. Come on, quickly. We are able to even test you in this very short, rapid format, because as always, improvement is the most important thing on Chess Base India. If you can improve, you can guess the moves, you can become a stronger player.
Hope at least 15 pages of your World Cup training notebook have been filled, you know.
Amruta, very strict teacher there. Yeah, let's
I'm
have
sure
a
they're writing, guys. Hashtag ChessBizIndia on Instagram if you're making notes of your answers.
Yeah, if you're doing that, that would be great. By the way, great answers by Swapnil Gupta,
Shaunak Rajans, Divya Shri, Siddharth Jugaye, Hema Singh, Olivia Datta, Tanvish Reddy, Chinmay Kelaskar, Shri Kumar Yeh, and Krishna Gulati.
Yes, the idea is here to give a check 93. If you take with the rook, then I win your rook on d1. If you take with the queen, I take on queen and then take the rook. If you take with the pawn here, then I'll win your queen anyway. Yeah. So that is a very powerful move. Right now Dubo has taken on e5, so he has won a pawn. But Amruta, now it's
yes.
time for Gukesh to think what to do. Should he go queen b4 here,
mm-hmm.
queen b6, because
queen
this queen
is also
attacked.
Possible queen e7, because there can be a pin on.
But Amruta, play. Queen e7, ed5, I think you're just pawned
rook
down.
F8?
Rook
no,
f8, okay. Maybe rook e3. So let's say if I go queen e7, ed5. And if I play rook f8, then rook e3, and already
right.
white is better. So I think Gukesh will go for queen b4.
Right.
Let's have a look at what Padmini is
but
doing.
But what I like about that position, just to tell you, that Gukesh has managed to create a lot of tension and complications.
But he's lost a pawn.
But white's king is weaker. So I'm not sure. Let's see.
Yeah, I mean, if for example, queen b4, ed5. Now you are playing for two results, right? You are pawned down, whether you will get this pawn or not. So it's just like yesterday. Gukesh will hold on. He will fight a lot. But his position is worse. There is no denying that.
Okay.
Padmini Raut in this position. Rook h8. Then she went c3. No, she went rook f2. Bishop c6. And now bishop a3. So Padmini maybe wants to go queen d3 to c4 and maybe try to put pressure here.
Oh, but queen d3, there is always bishop b5 if
yes.
she wants to kick away. But then queen e4.
Or maybe start with c3. I don't know.
Ah, like... c3 I like. So rook f2 is a nice idea. Very interesting, because you are in a way getting out of the pinning ideas. Discovered
yes.
ideas.
This... But also Padmini and Sara yesterday played opposite colored bishop positions, today as well. Okay, quickly checking what Vidit is up to. Has his position improved, or has fear been able to put some fear in his mind? Not really. Bishop c2, b5.
Ari, this is what we discussed, but is b5 not a good move?
Yeah,
I like it actually.
I mean,
because
it seems like Vidit, see, I really trust Vidit in such decision making, because he understands the dynamics well here, and he sees that keeping here the pawns
right.
better is to play this AB bishop b5, and after that maybe push a4 as well. B2 would be slightly weak.
No, white will not allow. So that is the question. Sorry. After b5, what is happening is you are left with one a pawn, okay, and then b4, and suppose this gets exchanged, then white will get a passed pawn because you have double pawns here. The other option was why you allow white's b4. How would it create problems even if you allow b4?
No, I don't think that was a problem as such, but Vidit just felt that
b5
is better
forcing.
For him, because after ab bishop b5,
and now let's say if I go b4.
Yeah, but b4, I think you're just letting me to create a4, and I think black cannot lose now.
Good hold.
Yeah, it's a very nice position.
Okay.
But b3 may be what he can do. He can stop a4 for some time and then slowly try to put pressure. There could be rook c8, but then there is
rook c3.
Yeah, you have to calculate. You have to calculate here. King e1, take king d2, then you take on a5. So that... You know, Amruta, this looks closer to a draw than white winning this.
Right. Closer to a draw and not as simple as it seems. Like, there can be complications which will be arising, I believe.
Mm. Also, if you are very careless, then rook e8 and e2 is a possibility in this position.
Oh, nice.
Okay. Going to Gukesh's position now. Gukesh went queen b4. E takes d5 has happened. He's taken the pawn on a4, which is what was his idea.
Why?
Yeah,
why?
Because D6 and Dubo. I can literally imagine Dubo playing like, with his style, like pushing the pawn to D6. Now this pawn is so dangerous, Amruta, because it is just two squares away from becoming a queen. Also, the F7 point is slightly weak. Rook is coming into C7. So although Gukesh won the pawn, it was not a great idea to allow Dubov to push d6. Maybe a better try was Rook Ad8, stopping d6 for the time being. But okay, let's see if now Gukesh can use his epic defensive techniques, because losing the first game with Dubov would be very difficult to come back with White. I mean, Gukesh can hold Dubov really well, he's doing that, but to beat Dubov
Not easy.
is not
It's
easy.
not easy.
So now Rook C7 is the move, like Rook C7 with the idea of putting pressure here and on B7.
Yeah, I think he will play that because it's a
His
simple,
natural moves, yeah, for
yeah,
White. White's
pre-proven,
moves are not so tough.
pre-proven.
Bishop D5 played by Sara Khadem here. She just put her bishop on D5. And now Padmini Amruta has to figure out what to do. There is a plan which is very, very interesting, which is to go c4. And you, as black, you don't want to take, because queen c3 and c5 pawn becomes horribly weak. So you just drop your bishop back. But now what you can do is you can play your queen to f4, get your bishop to c1, put bd2 and try putting
And
pressure.
a3 b4 maybe later you could even try that, but still. This allowing the d4 protected passed pawn on
Yeah,
d5
not
with
easy.
the rook supporting behind the pawn, not an easy decision there for
Yeah,
c4.
yeah. Okay. Bishop to b5. And now bishop b3 has been played. Oh, so he has not played b3, Amruta. He's played bishop b3. He's put pressure on the d5 pawn. Now I
Then
think
it's a
it's.
good idea, right? You have two choices. First is bishop c, no, bishop c4, bishop a4, I would worry about. But
But
then
then
rook b8, rook
king.
b8.
Maybe even bring the king to d6.
No, rook b8 is good because I'm
Ah,
attacking
you're
b2, I stop b3 as well,
true, true,
and
true.
then king
Very
e6.
right. But okay, bishop b3. Vidit went bishop
Yeah, that is
c6.
also good, I think.
Bishop
No issues.
d1.
a4. Now a4 is
Yes.
just simple.
a4,
B.
b3, ab3,
Yeah, can you do that?
rook
Rook A,
8, bishop
B2?
8.
No, B2 is
Not
not
b,
possible.
and then bishop b3, and I think that endgame is drawn.
Correct.
Okay, guys, Vidit has
This is a
defended pretty
very,
well.
very simple. Like, so B5 decision was very calm and cool for him. I don't think he
I
was
mean,
ever worried
Amruta,
about
it's
his position even for a bit.
maybe not, but we were worried in general because of the doubled pawns, but
Yeah.
it could be true that it's just that black can easily defend this doubled pawn position.
Correct.
Now, Rook AD8 by Dubov, and the computer gives a huge advantage to White. Although in over the board play, you don't really feel it, because this pawn here is not queening, right? I mean, the maximum you can get is D7. But what is the problem? Like, for example, after Rook C7, the issue is that B7 is hanging, and let's say you try to defend it. Say, for example, you go Queen B4 and you try to defend it. Then the next move comes Queen C4. And I exchange, you take with the knight. And what is happening is that because of this depasser, your one rook is tied, and then these pawns become weak. So you will lose those pawns.
And the effect rook also. Oh, it's really bad. It's really bad.
So D7 has been
But he
played.
played d7. It's also as good as rook c7, right?
Yeah, he's pushed his pawn. But Amruta, now, can you try to win this pawn? Let's say there is
Yeah,
this.
what happens for knight d7? First important question
Dubov is
there.
so tricky. Knight takes d7. Guys, what is White's move here? White to play. Can you find it? White to move. Because it seems like it is winning a pawn for now. You take here, I take here, you take here, I take here. It seems like completely fine, but there is a problem.
One second.
Did you see it, Amrita?
Haven't seen it.
This has not happened in the game. Knight d7. The pawn is still on d7. It's not so simple. By the way, Satyavardhan, thank you for becoming backer of Indian chess. So kind of you.
So
the move that has been suggested by so many people is rook d3, but the right move is b3.
Oh, my move is also rook d3. So b3 by Olivia, Rajat, Aditya, Dominic, Scalpel, Rohan, Adyayan, Priyank, Random, Ajin.
Yes. The thing is, Amruta, if you play here rook d3, then after queen b5, I pin you like this. So there is a pin here, but I also pin you.
Wow.
So you're not able to win.
It's such a beautiful defensive move. This is also a question you should ask. Queen b5.
Yes. And here, the main move is b3. Because now I can't defend the knight. And if you go queen b4 attacking the rook, now I go rook cd3. And if you now try to pin me like this, I get queen e3, which is an additional move. So for example, here in this position, if you go rook d3, queen b5 and queen e3, then here after rook d8, okay? And this is already some problems. Because it's very complicated.
Rook d5. B2 pawn we're losing at the end.
And you take this pawn and attack here. But because I have played b3 here, then after, and I think this is all very difficult to calculate.
Exactly. This is, I would say, if you had a level for this calculation, what would it be?
Yeah, I mean, it would be very, very difficult. Because here, queen b5. Yeah. Queen e3, rook d8, somehow rook d5, you don't have queen b2. That is the key point. And that is what Gukesh is thinking right now, Amruta. He has taken the pawn. Oh!
So, Gukesh, if Dubow plays rook d3, I think even Gukesh, Dubow
then Gukesh's big, nice defense will come into the picture.
But is that also easy? Yeah, queen b5 may be
Gukesh has seen that rook d3, there is queen b5. That's why he took here. But when
he played d7, he would have seen b3.
I'm not sure.
Dubow play b3 or will Dubow play rook d3? Guys, what do you think?
Because,
will he find out?
The thing is, there is another move, rook a3 here, trying to attack the queen and distract it. But then you can take on d1. Queen d1 and knight e5 and then try to defend
then
this position.
Knight on c6 and... But I don't think it is easy to defend, right? This one, or is it possible?
I mean, it's much better than what could happen in the game. So here, Dubov's b3 is an important move to find. Otherwise...
Practically, I think he will go for rook a3. Dubov will play. He won't play. He will play. He won't play. Blindfold Chess, welcome to the backer of Indian Chess. Thank you for becoming a member. Yeah, rook a3, I think he will play.
Sorry. Okay, let's go to Padmini's game. We'll wait. I can't stand the excitement. Oh, by the way, Padmini did go c4, bishop b7, queen g5 was played. And now this position is becoming so interesting, Amruta, because Padmini is going on the king side when the queen king is on the queen side. And Sara is playing on the queen side. it's quite an interesting thing.
A4 is really, like, what?
Well, you could take, because then you want to open up things. But maybe now there are, it's just like, for example, I can go d3, maybe try to queen the pawn here, just push the pawn. Maybe there is also f6 in the position. So for example, I could think about going f6 here as well, but there is queen g7, correct? But if I play a4, ba4, f6, then queen g7, then after queen a5, attacking the rook on e1 and the pawn on a4, there is a lot of counter.
Are you telling me a4 was basically to vacate the a5 square?
For the queen.
And this is extremely difficult, Sagar. I would say it is impractical.
That's why Sara Khadem is such a strong player. Yeah, Amruta, she's playing really well.
A4 is so non-intuitive.
Yeah,
if you're
I agree
playing
with you.
That move, you're opening the b file. I mean, you have so many other moves to consider.
I would agree with you. By the way, Dubov has played b3, Amruta, now. And after Gukesh's queen b4, now he plays rook cd3. Brilliant. Guys, that is why Dubov is a world-class player. He has found this move, rook cd3. And now, what to do with this knight, yeah? It's so subtle that if the pawn was on b2, there was rook d8. And, I mean, there was queen b5 here. Now, if Gukesh plays queen b5, then Dubov can just even play queen b2, Amruta. This is another point of putting your pawn on b3. There is an additional square for the queen.
You vacated, right. So I think Dubov played really well this tricky idea with d7.
Yes, yes. No, he has understood that in order to subdue Gukesh, he will have to find very strong moves because Gukesh is very good at defensive calculation.
Correct.
Whenever Gukesh falls in trouble, like he's played queen b5 now, and Dubov has two good moves, queen e3 and queen b2. Both are pretty strong here.
What about Vidit's game? Have they progressed?
Yes, Vidit's game has progressed, but it's going at a slower pace now. So after bishop c6, a4, king e3, rook b8, rook a2, bishop b5.
So he's okay with bishop takes a4, rook takes a4, and rook b2. And that rook end game would be a draw.
Right.
Nice. Venkatesh is super chats and says, Sagar bhai, slowly the masala dosa is coming back.
Yeah. Thank you.
So this should end in a draw.
Yes.
I think Padmini's game is interesting. B3, yeah? He plays B3.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Already he's simplifying. A, B3, Bishop B3 and Bishop C4 should be.
Yes. I think
Bishop C4,
now holdable
and
here.
There is Sagar. If you play A, B3, Bishop B3, Bishop C4, then Bishop takes
I don't want to play Bishop C4. I'll first give a check. Rook
That's smart.
And I'll try to get in somehow.
Okay, that is smart. That is smart.
Okay, after queen b5, Amruta, a very important move has been played by Dubov here. He has played queen to b2. And guys, the main point here is that after rook e8, there is a very... okay, now you can just take here. That's just done. I was thinking that is an important rook d5 move, but you can just take on d7. What to do now? Gukesh might be thinking like take on e5. Yeah, he's taken on e5, rook d8, he's played queen c6. Oh my god. Now, guys, again, so tricky. This, as Nigel Short likes to call him, the tricky devil. That's what Gukesh is. He has given a check to the king, and the only move was rook 8 d5. Because wherever the king went, for example, let's say if the king went to h3, then after knight f3, there are ideas of queen e6 check, and there is, in general, the king is not safe there. And if you went king g1, there is still knight f3. If you went king f1, there is queen h1 check. So this rook 8 d5 is very nice. And now Gukesh goes knight g4, angling at knight f6, trying to win back material. But Dubov now has many ways, king g1 being one of them, just trying to.
With 1 minute, this is very difficult.
Yeah, this is lost right now. So Gukesh might have to start thinking about.
So
his...
in a roundup, it is very clear.
Gukesh
game
losing.
Will end in a draw. Gukesh will.
Oh, drew. They already drew. Very nice. That's a good result for Vidit because here, I think it's Fear only who played B3 and offered a draw, and Vidit accepted. So we'll go into game number two very soon.
So
meanwhile, queen c1, nice move by Dubov, offering a queen trade. And Padmini's game, she played rook b2, ab3, rook b3, and queen a5. So
that has happened on the board. And rook b1, if she plays right now, rook eb1.
Yeah.
What would be the problem there? Bishop just... To...
Maybe take here.
Rook b7?
Rook b1
check.
Check.
You can't go king. You have to go king f2.
Because
you
if
can't
you take,
take,
then there is a mate.
Mate
I go here.
Queen d2 is controlled, in fact.
Yeah, I
so
take.
So first, and then you take on.
Take
a3.
And queen a3. And now, see, the king is very safe. And the d pawn is very strong. It's actually this move a4 is such a genius move by Sara Khadem. I really like it.
Exactly.
It's a beautiful move. And in fact, now Padmini is in trouble because the queen is creating such nasty threats here. At the same time, this is a passed pawn.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'll update the scores as well, Amruta. so that people can see who's winning, who's not. Guys, we already have five Indians in the next round. Could be possible that we may add a couple more today. But let's see. Right now, Gukesh's chances look dim. Also, Padmini's chances look not so bright here with her opponent playing Queen A5. But Padmini's position is so complex that there could be mutual errors that could happen still. E3. And for the time being, Gukesh's game after Queen C1, Queen E6, Queen C2. Gukesh is still fighting. He doesn't give up ever. That's a good thing about him.
Yeah.
Let's
Any
stay with.
tricks there is Agar in
No,
Gukesh's
no.
game?
There
No,
is no trick.
nothing.
So let's
Yeah, with the
stick with
knight.
Padmini's
Okay.
game and try to see what.
So Queen A5, Rook B1 we analyzed. That was one of the moves. The other thing could be to defend your rook maybe by Queen
Queen G3.
G3. And you also defend the E5 pawn there. So
But
Queen
Queen G3, there
G3.
is D3. You can't take the pawn
Correct.
because after Rook takes, Queen E1 is hanging.
Yeah,
And
that would be a
D3,
pain.
D2 is a strong pawn
Yeah.
passer.
So then Rook D1 is the other move right now when you're saying D3. But I lose the E5 pawn. Oh my god. In fact, this is such a dangerous position suddenly. White's king is weaker than black's king.
How the tables have turned, that's the thing to notice here.
Yeah. Also, if you look at the position, like if suddenly somebody comes, I just have a look at the comment. Oh, black's king is weak. But nahi yaar, look deeper. This is all superficial.
Because the B file is actually trumped by the activity on the E file.
So what went wrong exactly? Like the very big thing. A5 was a good move, yes. So Queen G5. Queen G5 was something which really, you know, helped black that white's queen is somewhere else, not needed. That has affected. But is Sagar, anything on Murzin? Because today Murzin and Artemiev were going to play, right?
Yes, we will check the games, but right now let's stick with
Okay.
what's happening here.
Sure.
And Padmini has last 3 minutes left. On the mini board, we have put up Gukesh's game here.
Yeah, with its game has drawn, we are updating the scores. So right now it's. What is the move you guys can suggest, like the best defense for white in Padmini's game? Rook E2, Rajan says.
But I'm not a rookie to isn't D3 possible then?
Ah, D3 will come by.
I think Padmini is now thinking for over 5 minutes because she realizes the difficulties in her position.
Queen C1 is another suggestion.
Yeah, Queen C1.
Then D3 ko what's Rook D1. But then D2, the pawn can advance still.
Yeah, and then E5 is weak. Hey guys, just.
So rook after Rook B1 Sagar, if Rook E5, maybe then Queen G some move with where you don't take on B7. That is a possibility. Rook B1 is being suggested by many. Guys, Rook B5 would be a blunder because your even rook is hanging. So that won't be. Yeah. So all of us, the natural moves we have considered are Queen G3, Rook B1, Queen C1. Padmini, it's a tough position with very less time to defend. A4 had come from nowhere.
Yeah, I think we are back. We are back. Sorry for the
Yes,
small
yes,
lag.
yes.
Just trying to get the board. There was a small crash that we faced on the OBS, which is why a lot of things went down. And yeah.
So the problem with Rook B1, which a few of you are again asking,
Queen
are
G3 has been played. Queen G3.
yeah. Was rook takes e5 was happening. Maybe you can show the variation one more time. And if you take on b7, then it's lost. Of course, you don't have to take on b7, but
This is
this
the position
position.
which Padmini did not like. That's the reason why she's gone queen g3.
And now, most probably, Sara will go for d3.
Yeah, d3 actually is the only move, Amruta. And it's a natural move because you are pushing your pawn towards queening. The rook and the queen are defending, but the rook on e1 is weak.
Why are you saying it's the only move? Like, let's say I go bishop c6. She plays d3, but
Yeah, because if you
just
play
to
bishop
know.
c6, then I could go rook b1,
Ah,
and
now you
now
get some time.
there is no
Rook
d3
e5 is
coming.
also not there.
So d3 is a great move. I think Sara Khadem showing her real class here, but let's see if Padmini can make her go wrong somehow.
Yeah. At least the best way to continue would be rook d1, right? That would be the
Yes,
best.
I think right now rook d1 is necessary, and
She's
then
1.5 minutes. Just very quickly, we can see Gukesh's game.
yeah, let's see Gukesh's game. How is he
Maybe you
doing?
can finish the game.
No, it's fine. Gukesh fighting on, but he's being pushed
Oh,
back.
14 seconds is
I
the
can't
time is
believe
also.
that Dubov will go wrong here in this
Yeah,
game.
this one is very difficult. Okay, but then at least one good thing is Gukesh has white in the next game. It's not like he's lost from with white and then he has black. It's very difficult with these players, yeah.
Yeah, but even with white, it's not going to be easy. Let's see. By the way, rook d1 has been played, and now this d3 pawn is hanging. Do you play? Oh, she played d2, which was not the best move. Bishop
Really?
e4
But we
was the
also
best move.
thought d2, right?
Yes, and
What? Why?
now queen e3, Amruta, and this pawn is going to be under pressure. Queen e3,
So what should black have
bishop
played
e4, defending the pawn. That was the better move.
there? Ah, okay.
But queen e3 is what is a nice move. Also possible is to push e6, guys, because after fe6, fe6, if you take rook e6, then queen h3 pins like this. It's not
This
so
is tough.
simple. It's
Queen
not so simple.
H3 suddenly is tough.
Yeah, it's very
And suppose
tricky.
I defend Rook D6.
Yeah, if you play rook d6, then I could already put more pressure here.
King D7.
Yeah, and then suddenly I can go bishop c1,
Oh
so that if you
man.
take here, then I mean all crazy lines
Oh man.
I can take like this.
Oh wow. Are you should ask a question.
No,
This is
but
so
she's played queen e3,
difficult.
by the way. Just no, that was just crazy lines, guys. Not very not possible to play during the game, but queen e3. And now maybe rook d4 is a possible move. Actually, if you think about it, Amruta, the idea could be bishop b2 and bishop c3 and round up this pawn.
you are okay with queen takes a2. Ah, rook, your queen will get trapped. Rook. No, actually not.
Yeah, for example, let's say rook d4, then I'll go bishop b2 attacking your rook.
So I
So
don't have time to go queen a2.
yeah, otherwise I'm already thinking of
See, what
e6.
about bishop c6 with the idea of bishop a4 and there is this, you know,
Yes, that
double
could be the
attack.
move that she'll. By the way, she's gone rook d4. And now Padmini can go bishop b2. This is becoming very exciting. Meanwhile, Gukesh has lost his game here after the last move that was played by Dubov, rook c7. The b7 pawn was falling, and Gukesh has resigned. That means he's 1-0 down. I'll bring the scorecard on the screen after this game. Bishop b2 attacks the rook.
28 seconds for Padmini and 1 minute 53 for Sara. Super complicated position, but slowly white might start getting better.
Yeah,
Suddenly,
if you
the
take
king
this
can become
pawn,
weak.
then
Rook
already
d2.
queen d2 here, and then this should be around equal, this
The most
position.
important thing is you've defended the e5 pawn, and that was causing a lot of trouble down the e5. So, bishop b2, she is playing,
I
right?
think Sara would try to be more ambitious than taking the pawn here. She might want to go back and keep the pawn.
If she goes rook d7 or rook d
Yeah, rook d7. maybe
rook d3 I was
Padmini
thinking
can go rook d3, take, queen takes d3 and then pick
rook
up the
d8
d2
no
pawn.
rook d8 black will try to defend
Yeah, but there I have queen b3 and my pawns are also safe. Let's see where she goes. So for example, Amruta says rook d7, rook d3, rook takes d3, queen takes d3, rook d8, and now maybe just queen c3. Interesting, you know, like takes, I have e6, I have also my passed pawn.
I think for white it might start becoming easier slowly.
Possible.
Because the d2 could just become a weakness. And then the e5, f5 pawn would become so dangerous that look at Sara's time right now. It's
she
gone
is.
Down to 25 seconds.
And imagine, guys, over the board, this tension of the clock, 10 second increment per move. She took the pawn on c4 and now Padmini can just simply take. I think Padmini would be happy to just take.
Why
and
rook d2? Because if now the black king starts becoming weaker.
Yes, it's possible.
Rook e, no, rook e5 is not possible.
Maybe
sorry.
Rook e4 with the idea of queen e4, queen d2. But she takes
no,
with
queen
the queen.
e4, bishop e4.
Ah, sorry. So yeah, rook e4 was the plan there. So she's taken with the queen.
Okay. I think good decision in time pressure. Look at Sara's time.
No, she might have made a move. She might have made a move. Or did she lose on time?
No, then the result would have come. She will not lose on time.
Yeah, she might have made a move with just. But it's quite possible to lose on time also. No, she's
no,
played. She played.
Seconds.
You know, Amruta, she played her last move like queen takes d2. Here, queen takes d2 with maybe.
1 second in hand. Yeah, that's why it became.
G4 played by Padmini very quickly and now again Sara is down to 10 seconds.
Oh, G4, that G pawn.
Yeah.
My god. Bishop F3?
And if you count the pawns, it's 5 pawns a side, each H5.
Maybe H3. Then takes bishop F3. If you go H3, then HG, bishop F3. Oh.
No, the F3 square is controlled by the rook.
Forgot.
Yeah, we are also very nervous here, so you can imagine what's happening with the players. H5. This clock here is giving heart attacks, although it's not the most accurate. And sometimes over the board play, your clocks cannot sync 100%. Oh, by the way, something has happened which has given Padmini the advantage. G4, H5. She went rook G3, H4. Padmini went rook E3 and bishop B1. May not be the best move now. H3, what a move by Padmini, the best move in the position, because she has spotted that if the opponent takes bishop a2, rook a3, and this is winning, so she can't take the
wow.
What a nice move, Amruta.
Wow.
H3 is such a good move.
Exactly, this rook a3 tactic is beautiful.
Yeah, this Padmini saw in a flash.
Sara would have thought is after rook a3 bishop still can go to b1. She would have forgotten rook a8 check, there is no king d7.
And g6 is played now. E6 by Padmini, f takes e6. And now you can take here, play f6. What many moves? Fg6 is bad because bishop will take. I think f6 is a good move. She takes f takes e6 here. Maybe the pawn will get blockaded now. Perhaps a safe idea for black is to just go rook e4 and exchange the rooks. And
ooh, then if you exchange, do you lose the e6 pawn?
Yeah, maybe after rook e4.
That's why f6 was better. So that
yeah,
he
f6
a solid
would
pawn.
Have been better.
Mm-hmm. That was a good chance, right? There.
Here, yeah. Take f6, and maybe white still has some chances. But
anyway.
After fe6, bishop e4 was played. Bishop f6, rook e6, and bishop h4. So, opposite colored bishops, 3 pawns each on the board, should be ending in a draw. But, you know, with just a few seconds on the clock, you never know what can happen.
Also, now whose king is weaker, would you say? Or does it matter?
Maybe not. But look at Padmini. She's going all out for the attack. She went check. King here, check. And now Sara can
king
just
C6.
Put her king on c6.
It's helped her king to actually
yeah.
come forward.
It's helped
and
black's
a2
king.
Is now, again, Padmini has to waste to move to defend the a2 pawn.
Mm-hmm. a3 maybe.
But then, Sagar, Rook c1 check will happen and c4 c pawn will
She
still
went rook
start
d6.
rolling, right? That looks very dangerous. Now going f2, rook c2 check. Rook d2. Maybe just go back rook d2. I think
No, but
c7.
king f2, rook c2, right? King e3, attacking the bishop. She goes rook d2.
Yeah, much safer. Ooh, 18 seconds and
Take
takes.
on b3.
Okay, the good thing is you have a pawn take on b3, so it can defend a c4 idea for a while.
And how
Or are
about
you
going
losing
bishop
it?
f2 now? So that
So
if
bishop
you take
f2, rook
on
b3,
b3,
bishop
I
takes
take on
d5,
c5.
and then rook h3.
That's happened. Bishop c2, she's taken
So
on
first
h3.
h3 she took,
She's
bishop c5, rook
taken.
b3.
So she'll be pawn down.
And g4 is falling or not yet?
Yeah, this is some
g5.
defensive. Maybe king f2 first, just improve.
Then black will not get g5. So this should be able to hold.
Yeah,
The only thing
the
is.
reason why this is holdable, guys, is because the c pawn, no matter how much it advances, at some point, black can blockade it. Like this bishop and rook can blockade it on a dark square, and it's not so simple for the king to come all the way and try to promote it. So check, but still it has to be carefully played by white. So here rook g3, check king here, and isn't she losing another pawn, Amruta? What was
That's
on
what I thought,
Padmini's
that
mind?
g pawn is already weak, so
Yeah.
g5 was something which I felt was necessary.
Here, maybe this check was not a great idea. Rook d4 was the best, I guess. But check here and
I think
now.
this check was more like a time pressure move. You have 1 or 2 seconds. What do? You just give a check, and then after king6, it becomes a double attack. Your c5 is
The
hanging, g4
margin
is
of
hanging.
difference between someone who wins and someone who loses in this tie breaks is so less. Like Padmini here, she might have played 50 moves well, but just these last couple of moves, she in time pressure made a couple of wrong decisions, and now she's facing two pawns. It seems very difficult to hold now.
Yeah, I also think they are very distant here, 3 files apart.
Yeah, Vidit's second game will soon begin. I don't think they'll wait for all games to end, Amruta. But still, just to like all other round one games, but to give you an update about what has happened, Mkhitaryan Krikor lost to Mamedyarov. Sindarov and Alireza drew.
Oh, again. Oh,
So they
Sindara
are,
was white.
yeah,
Okay.
but they are still fighting very neck to neck. Vakido
Wakor
beat
Jahangir.
Domingues, which is a big result.
Wow. Is Jahangir not the coach of Sindara?
No, he's his friend, I believe. So they both from Uzbekistan fighting hard. Vidit and Fear drew their games. Esipenko versus Guen Thai Dai Van from Czech Republic draw. By the way, Nguyen Dan Thai Dan Van is a Vietnamese name, but he represents Czech Republic and is a strong 2588 youngster. Daniil Dubov beat Gukesh Murzin versus Artemiev. You had asked me to show this game, Amruta. And right now, Murzin, this should be a draw. But perhaps this extra pawn.
Again, such end games need such
Yeah.
accurate play that it's not so easy,
Not easy, not easy. Agreed.
especially with players like Artemiev. Oh,
Yes.
Maksudlu
Maksudlu
versus
lost to
Kirill.
Kirill
My
Georgiev.
God, that's a big
Wow, that's because
upset.
Kirill Georgiev is around 50 plus years old.
And also, he is 2594. I mean, he was black.
Yes, and another big result, Yakovenko Dmitry losing to Timur
Okay, but Timur can beat
Garev.
anybody.
Yeah, Salem Saleh beat Injik. And Ravi Haria playing
Oh,
beautifully, fighting with Etienne Bacro.
nice. That is a
And
very good result. Gorgish
Grandelius
Ferenc
Nils.
drew with Tabatabai.
Yeah, Grandiloquent Nils, Akkobian Draw, Burke. Oh, there are so many games. No, Amruta, 22 games out of 64 have gone into the tie break.
That's huge. And what
Yeah.
about Shiro? Shiro lost
Shirov
with
lost to
Zerebo.
Zarebo. And okay.
Okay.
Let's see Padmini's game and see where it is leading us to. Padmini is still fighting hard, but I think Sara is slowly beginning to get her pieces in order and the c pawn is moving forward. So
Yeah, this is a little difficult to defend. In fact, very difficult. Also, for Padmini Sagar, next game she's going to be black. So, well, would be very hard to
yeah, it you know Amruta, it seemed
strike
like
there.
Padmini would get at least a draw.
Yeah.
In the end, she had defended everything,
Correct.
and maybe she also stopped calculating for a bit, and losing this g4 pawn turned out to be a big loss. Like
I think
you
it would
had
be big.
mentioned here that maybe,
G5.
but g5 rook g3, and then you lose that pawn. So
Still,
she
so
went
you have to
here,
rook
here,
f2.
here.
So now bishop f3 is still a threat. So rook d4, bishop f3, king f2 is the point.
Oh, look at, by the way, this idea, bishop e7, rook g4, and pinning like this could have been a way to continue.
No, but Sagar, what about direct rook d4?
Yeah, direct also possible. And
Because
then
rook g4. Oh, anyway, king
king
e3,
e3.
bishop f5. But
But
is this a draw? I'm not sure,
this
right?
should be a draw. This should be
How?
a draw.
How
Yeah.
can it be a draw? Because.
Because the thing is, it's very difficult to push the pawns. Like I go bishop e7 and I put my king d4. You can't get c5, you can't get g5. Seems like a very
Oh.
weird position. But I mean, I
So it
understand
was
the
not
pawns
very
are.
easy for a tense,
No, it
tensing
was not
game.
at all easy.
Actually, it was not, yeah. So I would say the bigger mistake would be to give rook d8 check, which did look very attractive and tempting there, rook check, this check, but it helped the black king to come forward.
Yeah. No, that position was a very exceptional one with three files pawns being apart, yet white having some defensive chances with bishop e7 and king d4. Okay, king f3.
Jaikar Pandurangan says, Sagar, opposite bishop ending, if the pawns are three or more files apart, it is a forced win.
Yes, but sometimes you know there are these positions
Exceptional
where the
positions are
king,
always.
wherever the king goes, the other king follows. And in that position, it's even if it is more than three files, there can be chances of draw. So like you know, so not always that's the case. Somehow, you know, Padmini has set up kind of blockade where this bishop and rook stop the pawn and this bishop and king stop this pawn. So, how long will this blockade last is the question.
So king d1, rook a6, rook a1.
Like this.
Yeah, and then c1.
Yeah. I'll just also put up the scorecard, Amrita. That will help people to.
So guys, we are just updating the scorecards. The first round of tie breaks today is almost coming to an end. Now the second round will begin in some time. Vidit drew against Fear with black pieces, so he'll be white in the next round. Padmini's game right now is going on, and this is a lost position. Let's see if any miracle is possible here. Gukesh lost to Dubow with black pieces, and he will be white in the next game. He will need to strike back and Most probably the same with Padmini. Those are the results for all those who've newly joined, and we are having the scorecard.
Okay, so go one, draw here. Oh, by the way, the game has ended because you know, Amruta, this is the way in which the blockade was broken with Rook D2 and King D1, and now
Oh,
you know the
Rook D2.
bishop's
That is
activity
very
zone.
nice.
And yeah,
She
so.
did it in style, yeah.
Yeah, big result actually there for Sara Khadem because she has been, you know, struggling to get the measure of Padmini in this match, but finally she was able to, and in a game where we didn't expect it, right, Amruta? Because
Yeah, somehow I
opening
thought.
had gone Padmini's way.
Exactly. I mean, you can't lose that position, but it was very complicated. Preparation was very good. I don't know if Sara was aware of ideas where long castle does happen, because I think that was the game changer,
Yeah.
the move long castle. And well, but let's see. Padmini is a super fighter,
Yeah.
and
I have actually, I
I
feel
still
that
think there is
Padmini
some.
knows, you know, has been in so many must-win scenarios in different tournaments like Olympiad, Nationals, all of this. She might have great chance of comeback. While for Gukesh, I feel it's very difficult to come back against Dubov. But you know that boy is, of course, amazing. We can never write him out. Any games left which are going on? Actually, all games have been completed, Amruta. All games. So
So I
that's
think we are gonna have the round very soon
very
then,
soon we'll
very
start.
soon, if
We'll
you.
start very soon. And so, yeah, these are round two tiebreak games. We'll be starting very soon again. A few announcements that need to be made so that you guys are aware. Tomorrow, we will have round number three, Amruta, already in progress. That will
Okay.
start. And in round number three, we will have Hari Krishna taking on Constantin Lupulescu, who is rated 2659 from Romania. So this pairing is already out. Nihal Sarin will take on Dimitri Andrekin.
2724.
Yes, very strong player. Pragnananda takes on Michael Krasenkov, 2591.
Yeah, very highly experienced player here, so rating is one thing, but a very strong player for sure.
Yeah, and also Harika versus Valentina Gunina. This has also been finalized. So one player from India who is qualified but has not yet got an opponent is Adiban,
Oh, because
because
that depends on today's tie break between
Vidit and Fear. So
Acha.
whoever wins between Vidit
Oh,
and
okay.
Fear plays Adiban in the third round. And these are the things that will happen in the next round. A few of the nice pictures that I have collected, which I wanted to show all of you, are the following. This is Anish Giri. Anish Giri won his game yesterday, match 2-0 against Savchenko. And these are pictures by Eric Rosen and Anastasia Korolkova. And he will now face Nodirbek Abdusattarov, who beat Arvind Chidambaram. This is Arvind, who lost to Nodirbek there. Nodirbek showing some brilliant preparation. Bhakti Kulkarni, who fought very hard against Natalia Pogonina, but had to end her trip to Sochi. She lost yesterday. Look at these pictures, Amruta. Magnus Carlsen arriving to the tournament hall there very nicely in this car. And what I really liked is, you know, the way in which he came out, like very stylish. The car looks amazing, and
Chess
Magnus,
hero, yeah, he looks like that chess hero.
he looks like a James Bond kind of a movie
I
hero.
think he looks very similar to that guy,
Matt
Matt Damon.
Damon,
Matt
Matt
Damon.
Damon. Yes, there was a
How many
chess-based
of you
prank.
agree?
There was a chess-based prank which had happened where, you know, they on 1st of April, they had said Matt Damon and Carlson long lost siblings or something like that. And this was, you know, him giving autographs. Look at this, so many people here trying to get Magnus's autograph. It would be so nice to, you know, be in Sochi right now. This is Gukesh versus Dubov. Two fighters, and look at Gukesh's focus there. Dubov, of course, being pushed hard for every point against the youngster. This was Hari Krishna who beat Quezada Perez. Hari Krishna looks so smart, you know, Amruta. He has always a nice posture in which he sits on the board, and
especially he has very good hair.
Yes, very
right,
good.
Sagar?
Yeah, Amruta. Something which, I mean, two things which I don't have that Hari Krishna has. 2700 plus ELO and also hair. And Nihal Sarin here playing tremendous chess, going into the third round, looking very smart, you know.
Yeah, Nihal has become taller.
Not very tall. If you see our vlogs, in that he looks still quite short there. But as you, if you see here, you will see that Prag and Arvind.
You can't really understand with the distance.
This is Prag, Arvind and Nihal coming to the tournament hall. And look at Pragnananda here. So such a beautiful picture, Amruta, this one. You as a photographer would like it, right?
This exactly. I really love this because the emotion you can see in his eyes.
Love for chess.
It's like, yeah, he's so but it's so calm at the same time. You know, there are photos where there is, in the eyes, you can see a lot of aggression and a lot of this will there. You want to beat your opponent. But this one is a little different emotion. I like it.
Also, you will see the entire chessboard in his eyes, which is always a photographer's dream, you know. And this is another picture of Prag. Prag and Nihal both playing tremendously. We have Nihal now reaching number 79 in the world rankings.
That he is a rated... huge, huge boost, I would say, because being in top 100 is so difficult, first of all. And then with this, you climb up, you kind of become in that list where there are invitations start happening, super tournaments. So this will surely help Nihal. I think it was a great decision that he traveled for a month and gained some rating.
In Serbia.
Not easy decisions, all of those.
And guys, today Anand versus Kramnik will happen. The third game of the no castling match. We will cover it later in the day. Just to inform you, Vedika's chocolates are still available. The first link is in the description. There are a few packs which are left. The premium pack has 32 chocolates. The regular pack has 16 of them. So you can go and check it out in the description. There are links so you can get them. Vedika is a very, very budding chocolatier and also our very good friend and of course sister of Vidit Gujarati. Very good player, very good creator. And also, guys, there are certain books in our shop which are available. Chess Tactics from Scratch, which has been the bestseller, Books of Gelfand that have come, then Magnus Carlsen, Chess Patterns, Yusupov books, and all of this are available in the link in the description. You can check that out. It took us quite a lot of effort to get these books from all the way across, as you can see here, from Europe to India through the ship. And now all the books are in Chessbase India and you can get them at a very, very good price, discounted price, half of what they actually cost. So please do so and please get your favorite books. There is a catalog also below so you can get whatever you want. Now, back to action today. The second round is about to begin and let's have a look at it. Yes, the rounds are going to start now and it'll be very exciting to see. Guys, what do you think? Will Padmini be able to make a comeback? Kya lagta hai? No, Europe to India not by truck, Mayur. Europe to India in ship and then by truck from the port. Mr. Rack says Divya Deshmukh will take revenge for all this. Yes, maybe the next World Cup Divya would already be playing. Sam Roberts says Anish couldn't become the challenger, but imagine getting a Magnus versus Anish final here. Yeah, that would be very, very interesting for sure. Padmini will come back? No, maybe. Okay. What about the, what are your thoughts on Gukesh? I feel Gukesh's task is the most difficult because to beat Dubov on demand is never easy. But I think Gukesh would think like, if Dubov can beat Magnus Carlsen on demand, why can't I beat Dubov? You know, something like that. Guys, the results are on the screen for you to see, so there's no need to pin the results today. It's already there. Let me get the games here. Vidit will now have the white pieces. Do you think Vidit will go e4? I feel Vidit has a good chance now with the white pieces. But Vidit's match could also go into the next segment, 10 plus 10, if they are very solid. Because in this match, until now, no one has got an edge. Raghav Malviya says, Sagar, do you think it's fair to compare everyone with Vishy, even though there seems to be a gap between Vishy and other Indian GMs? No, actually, I mean, it's not fair to compare Vishy with anyone. I think comparisons are not needed to be made. What really Vishy has done is opened up the horizons. Like earlier, I remember that Indians, when before Vishy, everyone used to think ki grandmaster ban gaye na to enough hai. You know, that is the biggest thing. Like there was no GM in India at that point. So that was in itself. So when the first GM Vishy became, everyone thought, okay, now we can become a GM. Then when Vishy reached maybe the, when he became the world junior champion, everyone like, oh, we can even become world junior champion, the most talented junior in the world. Then when Vishy became World Cup champion, you know, he won the world championship in knockout format. We're like, okay, this is possible. Then he won 3 matches. So, you know, Vishy has been the barrier breaker in a way. Like the path, you know. He has been the trendsetter. So, that's the reason why I think it's the best to, you know, keep him that way, and these youngsters are very inspired by him. Now I also know many youngsters who say, who are like 5 or 6 years old, who say, we are inspired by Nihal Sarin and Pragnananda. So you see, it's like a chain reaction. Earlier it was Vishy, now Nihal Prag got inspired by them, then now everyone's getting inspired by these youngsters. So more relatable, right? These youngsters. Mr. Rack says, I'm thinking of an Olympiad team, Nihal, Prag, Gukesh, Arjun. Bring on Russia, yeah? True. Maybe Raunak there, Leon there. There are more youngsters. You see Aditya Mittal doing very well. Pranav did very well. We have Prithu Gupta, who is a very strong GM, youngster. Inyan is there. So many. Arjun Kalyan recently became a GM. Yash Dubey. Is Srinath playing world because saw him in photograph? No. He is the coach of the men's team. And coach of the women's team is Abhijit Kunte. And kudos to both of them, you know, being there. I'm sure they are a big help to the players. Tapan Krishna, kaise ho Sagar bhai and Amruta ji, finally ordered Vedika's chocolates. Oh, very nice. Good to know. And I'm glad that many, yesterday, there are only few which are left. So if you want to get Vedika's chocolates, then please do order. This is the last few packs left. Okay, guys, the games will start very shortly. I think in a couple of minutes, yeah. Maybe.
Until then, we are all having dinner. You all can also eat something.
Yes, Gajanan Joshi, why not? Vedika's chocolates can be delivered anywhere and everywhere across India. Parbhani, of course.
Predictions right now, and you have any?
I feel that Vidit game will end in a draw. They will go into 10 plus 10 segment, maybe. I mean, I also think he may win, but maybe it'll, because the match has been so tight, you know, between them. I think Gukesh will find it hard to break through against Dubov.
And
And Padmini
Padmini?
may win. That's what I feel.
Okay.
Of course, these are all
What are
random.
your predictions, guys?
We also had a new member, Mohan Reddy, who's become backer of Indian chess. Thank you so much. Manit Mohapatra, who's gonna be the Indian captain in this Olympiad. Not sure yet. We'll get to know in the coming days. We'll keep you updated.
So,
Raghav Malviya says, please give a shout out to Indian Olympic team. Oh yes, Olympics gonna begin in a week, I believe, Amrita,
yeah,
in Tokyo. And we are so
Sindhu is
excited.
also there.
PV Sindhu. There are so many other people who will get to know. I haven't been following much of news generally. You know, earlier, Amrita, when I was young at home, there was a TV, and I used to follow all the Olympics like shooting, weightlifting,
Right.
boxing, everything I would follow. But now, with our new house here and with no television, it's going to be not easy,
I
but I think it will be streamed on some platform, right? It would be nice to figure.
think with your new passion since 1 year of streaming.
Maybe we'll stream something. Okay,
Okay, I
Santosh Nene
think.
says, Vishy's like lighthouse of chess, guiding and helping many young and old Indian players to achieve what they are conquering. Agreed,
Game
agreed.
started, game started.
Game have begun and Vidit has played the same opening, but some difference. Bg2, knight c6, queen a4, check, bd2, knight d5. Remember, yesterday he had played bishop takes b4, nd b4, castles, and then knight a3 and rook b8, queen b5. Aisa hua tha, something. Today he went queen c2. So this is a new move. b5 by Alexander Fear. A4, BD2. I'm very interested to see who flinches first. Knight BD2, Knight B4. So still playing very fast. Queen C1, C6, and B3. And oh, Fear instantly moves. C3. Knight E4, C2. Still both of them playing very fast. Arey yaar, kitna theory. Everyone, like both of them, are so well prepared. I think Fear has come. And Vidit plays a5, and I think this might be a new move. We'll check in our chess-based database, guys. मजा आएगा देखने को. If Fear starts thinking here, then it's definitely a new move in the position. Yeah, he's thinking, guys. Okay, let's quickly see कि क्या मतलब क्या प्रिपरेशन है. d4, knight f6, c4, e6, knight f3. Pardon me if the move order is wrong, but knight c6, queen a4, correct. Check, bd2, knight d5, queen c2, b5, a4, take, take, knight b4, correct. ऐसे हुआ ना. Knight b4, queen c1. यहां देखेंगे. What's happening? Can't find. Maybe it's the database is right now connecting. Okay. Maybe it's already. Oh my God. Is it like Vidit has played something which is very rare? Guys, look at this. This move here, queen c2, इज वेरी रेयर इट सीम्स. हाँ ओनली 9 गेम्स, इसके लिए तो 9 गेम ही है. B5 A4 टेक्स टेक्स एंड येट फियर वॉज सो वेल प्रिपेयर्ड. क्वींसी वन, दे आर फॉलोइंग वोइटास्टेक शैंकलैंड गेम. B3 C3 94. वेन डिड दिस हैपन? वोइटास्टेक शैंकलैंड अभी प्राग मास्टर्स विच वॉज वन बाय. एंड हियर BA4 हैड हैपेंड बट ही वेंट C2 एंड विद इट इंस्टेंटली प्लेड A5. वाओ व्हाट प्रिपरेशन गाइस, व्हाट प्रिपरेशन, अमेजिंग ग्रेट. दे हैव लुक्ड एट इट सो डीपली एंड नाउ आफ्टर A5 फियर कासल्ड विद इट इंस्टेंटली प्लेड क्वीन D2. मे बी विद इट विद इट्स प्रिपरेशन हियर. अक्षय नातू, जस्ट बिकॉज यू स्पोक ऑन द सब्जेक्ट फ्लैश बिन ज्वाइन आर डिस्कसिंग द इंडियन कॉन्टिजेंट एट टोक्यो मेडल चांसेस इवेंट्स ऑन ए स्ट्रीम एट 7:45. ओके ग्रेट गाइज, डू चेक देम आउट इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन द ओलंपिक्स. वी ऑल्सो हैव अ मेंबर विपुल शर्मा, थैंक यू फॉर बिकमिंग बैकर ऑफ इंडियन चेस. कार्तिक तिवारी, लाइक नो कास्टलिंग चेस हिस्ट्री, प्लीज टेल अस अबाउट द फर्स्ट टाइम यू वेंट टू चेस ट्रिप टू कवर द गेम्स. ओके मे बी इन द ब्रेक नेक्स्ट टाइम, इफ इन द नेक्स्ट ब्रेक. Let's check Gukesh's game. Gukesh opened with d4, knight c3, d5, bishop f4, bg7, knight b5, knight a6, e3, castles, h3, knight e4, bishop e2, c6, knight a3. Generally, when you are 1 point down, na, these players like Dubov and all, they start playing very fast. But this is a good opening chosen by Gukesh because it leads to kind of imbalanced positions where he would have some chances. Okay, so it's roundabout even, maybe slightly better for Gukesh. Let's see what Padmini is up to. Padmini has played her favorite system, which is the Grunfeld. And you know, guys, there are many ways to play the Grunfeld. There is a very direct way to play Grunfeld, which involves the move c5 and then queen a5 and then theory and then queen takes d2 and many lines, sometimes picking up the a2 pawn. And there's also another way which Padmini in a must-win situation is playing, which leads to slightly inferior position because you give white a very strong center, but at the same time, c5 and now. It's basically you take a slightly inferior position so that it doesn't end in a draw very soon. So it's more like you want a fighting game, and that is why here d5 and white has a good position in the center. But Padmini is like, I want a long game, I don't want a theoretical one where Sara knows everything. Let's see. Meanwhile, after queen d2, Queen e7 played by Fear after quite some thought. You know, he thought for 3 minutes. With it, castled again instantly. Rook d8. And now, I think the first think of the game for Vidit here. So let's try to understand what's happening here. So this knight defends the pawn. This knight defends the knight. This queen defends here. So how to win this pawn? So one thing that I was thinking about is knight e1. कि जाके चलो ये पॉन खा लेते हैं. But this is not a good idea because I have taken back one of my piece. How can black get an advantage here? Why is knight e1 a bad move? Guys, come on, quickly. Let me know the answer. What is the best move for black here? See, the moment you move your piece behind, there is a chance to hit in the center. And let me see if how many of you have got this right. Just a second, let me get the board here so that someone wants to think. Yeah, can think as well. F5 is a move, but F5 doesn't help so much. E5, all those who have said E5, well done. Excellent job. E5 is the correct move. Olivia, Arush, Himika, Aditya, Sia, Cubing, HH, Riddhi, Asta, and Naveen. So here, the move that is really good is E5, and you break in the center. And even though you don't have time to win this pawn, so that's the reason why here Vidit went knight to C5 first, which is maybe the best move in the position. And Vidit is like, now next I want to play maybe if the opportunity arises here, I want to push. Let's say guys, I'm just asking you, if suppose you go h6, why is this a big blunder? What is Vidit's threat here? Through this we will get to know what is his threat. So white to play. Excellent. Excellent job. Paramdeep, Sanjeev, Cyber Blob, Rohin Gupta, Ansh Sharma, Aranak, Jomraj, Samta Patni, Venkatesh S, Inquisitive Knight, and Rahul Khandelwal. This is the move here. E4 is coming in the position. The knight has to move, and queen takes B4 is hanging. So that's the reason why here a very good move was played by Fear. He went knight A6. And now Vidit took the pawn on c2. Amruta,
Hi, this is so
they
what is
played a
it?
theoretical game again. Vidit has more time because he was better prepared this time, and he has recovered his pawn.
Okay.
And it seems like he has a small edge in the position. Now the question is, should you take with the queen or the pawn? He took
Took
with the
with the
queen.
queen.
Queen takes, d takes. Now, interesting moment has arisen because knight d4 and c6 could be weak.
Correct. I mean, so many tempting moves. A6 is a possibility. No, but a6 means knight b4 and you might lose the pawn. Later in the future, Sagar, maybe e4 could be a possibility. But I like the move knight d4. I really like knight d4. You're putting pressure here. He has to take a call. Bishop d7 or bishop b7 both look a little ugly.
Yeah,
I don't see
slight
any.
plus for Vidit.
Yeah,
And also
perfect.
bishop b7, I have a6. I
Ha,
can just
right.
push you away.
You can lose the pawn. So maybe knight b4, then you
No,
lose
I
the
think
pawn.
best is knight bishop d7
So
here.
knight d4. Here.
Bishop d7, black to play. Knight d4 and bishop e8. Just keep the bishop there defending. If you play e4, I'll move my knight
Maybe
away.
b4.
Yeah, I'll just move my
But
knight away
I'm.
somewhere, like
Yeah,
for just the
suppose
knight
b4.
before. And the thing is, your bishop is closed. And if you play
Yeah,
e5,
then you
of course
get
the
back
knight is
knight to.
hanging,
Right,
but
sorry.
the knight will go back to d5. So,
Yeah, I
in a
know.
way, this position, although looks attractive for Vidit, may not be easy to break through. And this is the thing about these games of Catalan, Amruta, that if the opponent is well prepared, it's not so easy to get, to confuse him, because here bishop d7, bishop e8 is an idea which a player like Fear will find.
Yeah, it's very solid. He's played bishop d7. In fact, it's happened on the board. And Vidit also may need to wait and not go immediately knight d4 so as to keep the options of knight e5 open as well. Or even knight d2, knight e4, knight d6 could be an idea there. Decisions like in future you want or you don't want a6, that's there. Where
The
should you
game
be
is far
placing
from
the
over.
rook? Yeah, so this should go on. Rook maybe doubling on the d files. Moving to the other game.
Gukesh is playing with white against Dubov.
Okay, and did you check the opening already?
Yes, I checked it. So we
So
were at
where are.
move 12, c3. So this was a decision that was made by Dubov, which was very interesting. He pushed the pawn to c4, c3,
C4.
Bishop e5, c4, c3, b5, knight b1, a5. And I get a feeling somewhere that Dubov is very happy with what has happened here with the position.
Right.
He has a queenside
majority
pawn flowing.
Queenside pawn storm there.
A4 could have been a very interesting move here, Amrita.
Yeah, generally for A5, and when there are pawns on A5 and B5, A4 is the natural response. And what in this case, if black will go for B4?
Yeah, the reason is of course
because
that
B3
B4
is not possible here.
I would think maybe B3, B takes C3,
possible?
Knight B1. This is a very common idea.
It's possible here.
So maybe Gukesh could have done this, but he went directly b3, bishop f5, and now a4. Wow.
This is also very solid right now, what he has played. No, and black
Amrita,
should consider
black's queenside is getting a bit in trouble, right? Bishop f5 was a bit careless move by Dubov, I feel. Like, he could have played here a very strong move.
b4?
No. b4
f6?
Means... No.
With the idea of
no.
No. One second.
This is a very nice move. Guys, you can think. Maybe guys can also think black to play. It's very difficult.
It's very difficult.
We have a super chat also here by Pran Krishna Barman
super chat and says, please suggest good book for beginner. I got interested in chess through your channel only. I was thinking about Soviet Chess Primer. Any better option? Definitely. That's a very, very
it's
good
a
book.
Book. Very interesting book. Just get it, read it. I would say to any players here who have begun with chess and are good at it, look at this. Kasparov says a remarkable book from which I learned to play chess, and a wonderful book by Anatoly Karpov. Just think about it. I think you will enjoy. The first book makes a lot of difference. And I would say Soviet Chess Primer is a great book. Heartily recommend it. And mods, if you can spam the link of that book, anyone who would like to buy it, I would say for tactics, chess tactics from scratch, for beginners to get like really interested. Even I get interested when I read this. Okay, so the move which is being suggested here is A4. Soham Kamotra winning with chess. Amritanshu Basra, Pragyanshu Chaudhary, Gopal Kedia, Sumit Velazil, Dhruv Garg, Abhishek Mehra, Ritik Lodha and Trivet Kulappa. And Amrita, the move is
yes,
to
what?
Play A4. And to close the queen side so that Gukesh has no way to make progress.
You know what happens? A4 comes to a binary and you say, no, come on, not A4. And that is how you discard it. So,
yeah.
Wow, amazing.
But bishop f5, and now Gukesh plays a4, rook c8, and Gukesh goes queen c1. Again, the best move in the position. Guys, Gukesh. If Gukesh is able to put Dubov under pressure,
he is, because a5 is going to be under pressure.
Yeah.
Big.
But why queen c1? Why queen c1? Can you tell me?
I believe his idea is to go queen a3. Am I right or am I completely
okay,
wrong?
Okay, if I take cb.
Right now, if you take cb, then I'll go knight b3.
Okay.
And the engine will go knight b3. What would you say? What do you want to go for? Let's say if you try to play b4, because you are having in the rook here.
ba.
Okay, BA. If you go BA, then of course first
rook A4.
Rook A4.
Knight CB5.
G7.
Knight CB5.
Knight CB5.
Oh, you have knight C5. You can put your knight on C5. But Amrita, why to put queen on C1? That is the question. Like,
so I think he defended C3.
Let's say I go H6 just as a random move.
No, when your queen is on D1, nah, you don't want to play.
No, I want to understand why queen C1 is such a good move.
So for that you try h4, because then you will understand the problem.
Or maybe I can think of this. So he takes here and attacks here. But even if I play queen c1.
You are threatening ab5.
And then I take, and now bc4.
And dc4.
And
here.
Now this is not hanging. Maybe queen c1 is just a very useful move.
No, your bishop d6 is happening. Are you winning a pawn?
Yeah, yeah.
Bishop d6, because if you go knight d6.
I mean,
no,
it's just,
not winning a pawn.
It's not winning a pawn, but it's a good move.
Correct.
But queen c1, very classy move by Gukesh.
Yeah.
He's actually just defending c3 with this move and putting pressure on this structure. a5 could become weak. If cb3, knight b3, knight can jump to c5, a5 could become a weakness. So,
very solid and prophylactic move also.
Yeah.
Vacates the d1 square anytime you want to go back for maneuvering anything like a move bishop d1 in future. You can go queen b2, double the rooks there. You know, the main problem when you have the queen on d1, you cannot think of developing it to c2. And you have your pieces here blocking the way for a long time. Whereas queen c1 is going to help the development pretty fast. Even if takes happen, then rook a1 comes in very fast. So
can we look at Padmini's game?
Sure.
No, I'm fine. Now I'm done. So b6, bishop e3, bishop b7. We saw till here c5, d5, queen d6. Padmini has played e5. It's typical Padmini chess. Opening may not be the best, but it's a fighting position. Queen is not the best blockader of passed pawn. I would love my knight to get here, but knight is at a one square diagonal distance here. So somehow I'm not able to make it reach there. It'll take time, and that's the reason why knight d2, knight c4 is a good idea. I think white is better, but Padmini is like, chalo khelenge. Like, let's fight. Let's see what happens. I'm ready to fight in this game. Okay, going back to Vidit's game. After bishop d7, Vidit went rook fd1. Bishop e8 has been played. My feeling of this game is that it will end in a draw. And we may go into 10 plus 10 segment. Somehow fear has, you know, prepared very well for this match. Has come very motivated and is giving Vidit a very tough time. At the same time, I think with its opening play in general, this Catalan with fear has been able to guess it. So maybe it's quite possible that Vidit will try to change with his next white game. He may not go for the Catalan. He may play something different. He can also play e4, right, on the first move. Vidit is a good e4 player as well. For now, it might be too soon to say to just dismiss this as a draw. I think there is still a lot of play left, but I see the pawn breaks. You know, generally, how you know whether a position is winning or not is when you see pawn breaks, at least my understanding of chess. And maybe it's not the best, but still, like, if there was some pawn break, like a4 in the position still left, and there could be. But here the structure is determined, you know. So that's why black's defensive task is a little easier. But now he's getting his king into the center, king e7. And now let's see what Gukesh. I'm very excited for Gukesh's game. So Gukesh ke game mein, he went cb3. Gukesh says, thank you, I'm taking the pawn. And the move that Amruta had suggested, b4. But wait, guys, I think Gukesh, if he takes on g7, king g7, and puts his knight on c5, he has good chances. Because, or he, if he goes directly knight c5 also. See, knight c5. ठीक है भी आइडिया इसको मार मार के ये पासर निकालने का ठीक है इफ यू टेक ऑन सी थ्री देन आई विल प्ले क्वीन सी थ्री एंड नाउ द ए फाइव पॉन इज वीक ऑल्सो द नाइट्स डोंट गेट दिस स्क्वायर सी फोर स्क्वायर ऑल्सो यू डोंट हैव बिकॉज द बिशप इज कंट्रोलिंग सो ऑल इन ऑल वाइट पीसेस इन दिस सिमेट्रिकल स्ट्रक्चर हैव मच बेटर स्क्वायर्स इन द पोजिशन सो नाइट सी फाइव हैज बीन प्लेड बाय गुकेश मतलब द वेरी फैक्ट दैट गुकेश गॉट अ गुड पोजिशन आउट ऑफ द ओपनिंग अगेंस्ट डुबोव इज अ ग्रेट अचीवमेंट ओके वन क्वेश्चन आई हैव इज व्हाट हैपेंस आफ्टर टेक एंड 96 बिकॉज आई वांट टू पिन हियर सो लेट्स से यू टेक ऑन जी सेवन किंग जी सेवन एंड नाउ ओ माई गॉड वॉट अ नाइस मूव गाइज वाइट टू प्ले वॉट डू यू प्ले हियर ये मूव भी याद रखना पड़ता है अरे यार कितना कुछ देखना पड़ता है बोर्ड पे यू हैव टू सी सो मेनी थिंग्स नाइनटी सिक्स मार सकते हैं इट्स ओके मूव बट ही विल टेक बैक विद द बिशप इट्स अ बेटर मूव So the move that you all are suggesting is knight e6, okay, but g4. ओलिविया, दिव्या, वेदांत, आदित्य, वरदान, अनिरुद्ध, श्रेय कुमार, चैतन्य, सुदीप, हर्ष ठाकुर. सो द मूव हियर इज g4 एंड बिशप e4 एंड नाइट d2. समहाउ दिस बिशप इज गेटिंग इनटू ट्रबल. Oh, by the way, guys, this has happened on the board. We have it. Knight e6 khela Dubov ne. Oh. Guys, aur ye bhi dekho. See, suppose if you take and I go g4, then knight c5, dc5, check to the king. Not easy. Will Gukesh take on g7 and play g4? Wow, that will be epic. It's not winning. But it's definitely putting a lot of pressure after knight d2. F3 is the big threat. Okay, what's up with Padmini? Padmini, wow, Sara got her knight to d2. Great move. Knight d7, knight c4, queen e7. Padmini is in a very bad position out of the opening, but she's like, let's fight. That's her motto for now. She wants to play f5, and maybe if e5, gf5, use her central pawns, or else push f5, f4. That's her plan. See how that works out. Meanwhile, Gukesh ka game mein knight e6 has happened. And let's see what's up with Vidit. After king f8, Vidit has gone into a long think. I don't know what here to do with white. Knight to g5 is Vidit's move. Okay. Vidit says, if you give me this pawn, I will snatch it. And if you don't give me this pawn, then my knight will swing over from g5 to e4 and go to d6. You know, weakness hunter. This is a weakness, and he wants to put his knight here and then get here. This is a key moment of the game, guys, after knight g5. Here, fear has to overcome his fear and kind of sacrifice a pawn, because see, he has to go knight c3. Now, how difficult or easy is it? We will see. Knight c3, Vidit will take on h7. If king g8, then Vidit can take on d8, and knight g5 back, and he's pawn up. But king e7, abhi ye mar raha hai, theek hai? So I take rook d8, and now the problem is this knight is getting trapped. So you will get your knight out, but now the rook comes in and the e2 pawn is hanging. So knight g5, the main point is to play knight c3 here for black. If I go h6, which is the most human move, you know, I want to play, then Vidit goes knight e4, which is a nice move, and then his knight is looking on d6, which is a very good square for the knight. So for example, knight b4, I can go knight d6, and suddenly this knight is a monster. Sometimes you can take on e8, and then this is weak. Sometimes you can even attack this knight, like, you know, just go rook c1 and rook d4. So I think fear has to take his time here to understand what to do. After rook d2, why not bishop f3 is the question in this position, right? Bishop f3. That is a good move, but after rook b2, even this pawn is hanging. And then you can go like rook a3, try to defend, but then check, king here. You're already in big trouble. b4, rook is trapped. Dekho. It's a weird, awkward move. If you keep making, you will get into trouble. So fear now. Let's see. If he plays h6 here, Vidit would be better. If he plays knight c3, then he understands this position very well. But it's not an easy move for humans to make, knight c3, giving up the h7 pawn. Okay, now we go to Gukesh's game. Gukesh took on g7, and Dubov cleverly did not take with the king, because he saw that agar main king se marta hu, to this diagonal, there is problem. So he took with the knight. But now Gukesh has a huge advantage, guys. Okay, I shouldn't get happy, or I shouldn't be too excited, because the main thing is that there's still a long way ahead in this game. But it's a huge edge. Like, you know, Rook FC1. And why is the engine giving white such a big advantage? See, sorry, there are no good squares for the black pieces to go to. And if I were, you know, the white knight can go to d2 to b3. This is a weakness. This knight is beautifully positioned. Now, even if you later come and take this, I'll take with the c pawn and get a passer. So I'm very excited for this game. But you know, it's one thing to get an advantage, quite another to convert. Vidit, what did Vidit's opponent play here? He went king e7 directly. Ah, he went king e7, but that allowed knight e4 to Vidit. The main aim of knight c3 was to stop this idea, knight e4, f6. And now Vidit has got his knight into d6, bishop g6. This is turning into quite the position that Vidit wanted now. Rook to c1. And guys, what is going to happen is that this bishop will take on d5. And then rook c1. Sorry, this is a great round for India. That's what I said. He's played rook c1. Good move. Vidit is getting a tangible edge against fear. And Gukesh, on the other hand, also pressing against Dubov. So, guys, I'm back. All good. I didn't say anything earth-shattering for now. Knight g7. And Gukesh goes queen to a3. Gukesh was a little bit uncomfortable with this pin. He plays his queen to the side of the board and knight e4 by Dubov. So next, now what do we do? Should we go rook fc1, defending this pawn? So rook c1, then maybe queen d6. Okay, I don't want to analyze too much here. Let's see what Padmini is up to. Her position has kind of metamorphosized into a structure. Take f4. Typical idea, guys. Whenever f5 is played and whenever you are ahead in development, you generally take and play f4. So here also the same thing has happened. E4, bishop f2, making way for the knight to sit on e3. And now Padmini is thinking. Positionally, she is not in a great situation. But let's see. I've been saying this again and again that she needs a fighting position and that's what she has got. Sometimes bad position is a bad position. Okay, let's go get back to Vidit's game. What? Aha, itta sara game nahi hua. I was like, what? Vidit ka game itta sara move ho gaya. Okay. Rook a c1 ke baad, Pierre has played rook a b8. Okay, let's think like GM. Okay, let's think like what you would do here if you are white. I would think of taking here one move, okay? E4 I'm thinking to kick the knight away. Then uska knight yahan jaake knight b4 it'll sit, right? One thing I'm definitely afraid of is knight b4, knight a6, and then sacking this on c5, rook c5, then rook d6. The knight on c d6 will get a little bit. What shall we do? I mean, do you think Vidit will take here? Because see, bishop d5, two moves. One is to take here, other is to take here. Suppose he takes here. Then Vidit says, I'll play b4. And then he just argues very simply that my knight is superior to your bishop. That's all I know. And I will then slowly try to play rook c3, rook e3, maybe try for f3 for break, maybe f4, f5. I mean, there are many possibilities in this position, so I will play that way. The other thing which Fear might do is after takes, he might take cd. And now, once again, Vidit goes b4. Now he has even the c passer. I like this position a lot, but Vidit decides not to take. He goes first rook b4. He's like, okay, I want to keep the option to take in my hand, and I want to anyway go b4. But now to e5, is Vidit planning to go to h4? That is an interesting square. I mean, the rook is slightly offside on h4, but okay, it's possible. Also, e5, somehow you can even just go back, and then the d5 knight is slightly loose, you know? So that could also be on his mind. Meanwhile, what's up with Gukesh? Sometimes, like the leeches thing, it just refreshes and all games end up on the first position. Okay, lot of updates have happened. Bishop b5 happened, queen d6, knight e4, queen a3, rook a3, bishop e4. And knight went to e5, rook c7. Okay, so Gukesh now has to figure out how to win this pawn on a5, because a5 is very weak over here in this position. So if I can get knight c6 and knight a5, that would be just what I want. So remove, see, magically, okay, sometimes it's good to think this way, magically remove all four rooks from the board. Then white is just winning this endgame, because go knight c6, win this pawn, finish. So a very good idea could also be to just go rook c1, rook a1, rook c1, and try to exchange down the c5. But maybe he will go rook c8 and stop that. There is also a possibility of playing f3 and kicking the bishop away. So knight e5, rook c7. Even knight c6, he may have to go rook a8. Then let's think. Like, I was wondering if we can go rook c3 with the idea of getting the other rook here. Oh, Gukesh goes g4. Gukesh is like, we'll trap your bishop with f3. Bishop go trap karenge. But bishop has a square on c2, it's not getting trapped. And Dubo can also go g5. G4 is a very interesting move, like a very gaining space. Okay, what about Padmini? How is she doing? Once again, it's not her game. Just picking out her game. Yeah, here is her game. In her game, Padmini, you see, Padmini, as mentioned, slowly, slowly she's trying to just fight back. Queen f6 attacks the pawn on c3, bishop e1 by Sara. Vidit, what happened to Vidit's game? So after, oh my god, he took a risk. Now after rook, see, these are the positions where you put your opponent in uncomfortable situations. Like, you are trying to play b4, he goes b4. Now this pawn could become a serious weakness. I'm also thinking, at the right moment, if you can take on d5 and then just shift your rook from here, you may even win this pawn. Minutes for Vidit, 11 minutes 52 seconds for Fear. Akshat says, thanks Sagarbhai for the coverage and getting us into chess. Since last year, I find myself playing chess during any free time. Great de-stressor. That's great to know, Akshat. Very cool. Very cool. But right now, I'm feeling a bit stressed. Because, you know, these knockouts, and especially the second game after the first draw, so tense. Just ek galti kar do ghar pe. Like, you're just out of the tournament. Just one mistake. The margin of error is so low. हाउ अबाउट थिंकिंग, हाउ अबाउट पुटिंग योर रुक ऑन सी फोर. मतलब इतना भी इलॉजिकल मूव नहीं है ना, लाइक आई वॉन्ट टू टेक ऑन डी फाइव एंड देन पिकअप दिस पॉन. ओ विद इन डिड डू इट, वाओ आई जस्ट मेड दिस मूव एंड ई फाइव हैज बीन प्लेड एंड नाउ विद इट कैन जस्ट मूव इज रुक टू एच फोर. Because if he comes down, then there is no point, right, to get this rook here. So he must go rook h4. Keep an eye on this b4 pawn with the idea of taking on d5 and then picking up the b4 pawn. He would be a pawn up then. Just let's make some moves. Like rook h4, what would be the move that black would play? There's no way to defend this. So I'll make a waiting move. What waiting move should I play? Let's say rook f8. Okay, just a waiting move. Then bishop d5, cd, rook b4. See, these are the moves which are very difficult to understand. That now, after d4, this rook is cut off. And then, if you have to play like take, take, it turns out that black is the one who starts getting counterplay. So, this rook is misplaced. So, anytime when you get your rook like this, it's a risk you are taking. It's like you are moving into one direction in your life, giving up all the safety measures. And as we saw in this line, if d4 comes in, suddenly the rook on h4 is like, what? I got cut off here. I did win a pawn, but I'm out of the game now. What to do? So this should not happen. Vidit has to time all these moves like bishop d5, cd5, rook b4 well. But on the other hand, fear is also human, right? He's not an engine. So in his mind, he should see ki cd5, d4 will cut the rook. If he doesn't see it, he might flip out and do something very illogical here. That's where chess becomes interesting. You know, it's not a game of engines. It's a game of thought. It's a game of concepts. Right now, Vidit's concept is like, first, Fear's concept here was Vidit will go b4 and I'll be like passive. So let me go b4. At least these pawns could be weak. Then Vidit's concept was like, I want to win this pawn. Now, let's see what Fear comes up with. Meanwhile, what's up with Gukesh? So Gukesh went g4, g5, f3, bishop g6. Okay, this is the position. Why is knight c6 not good anymore or what? He just goes and rook e8. But rook e8 is not a Dubov move. Dubov may not do this move like knight rook a8 stuff. Dubov would want to do something active. But there's nothing much active, right? Because the pawn is being lost. It's an important pawn. When there's no choice, you will have to play it. Padmini. Oh, Padmini. Look at this, guys. Padmini ka position now. Moving towards equality. Knight a5. And now, if queen b6. Cool move. Cool move. Queen b6 attacks the knight. Queen b6 has to take, right? b7. And now I give a check. Okay, maybe bishop f2 makes sense. Now I play queen b7, and the position is not is complicated. This is not clear. This is not clear. Guys, we have close to 10,000 people watching this. Please do like the stream, and if you haven't subscribed here, please make sure you subscribe. Let's try to push that up there. But for now, I am not very, very interested in how many subscribers grow. Very, very keen on what happens to Gukesh. Also, very keen on what happens with Vidit and Padmini. All are in the game. All are in the game. By the way, King e6 was played here by Fear. As we said, there had to be some move to be made by Black. Instead of Rook f8, which we were trying, he went King e6. Now, if you take, I will take back, and this is very human to play, yeah, bishop d5. But hey, what happens to e4? Just the rook is cut off. I don't want to play e4. No, e4 is not a good idea. But what should Vidit do is also a question, because if he can't play e4, if he can't take on d5, then what move next? You don't want to move your knight away from here. Okay, maybe king e1 is a good waiting move, because every move is like your pressure itta badhte ja raha hai, like fear has to do also 6 minutes left for Vidit. Somewhere in your mind, there should not be a doubt. Oh, should I draw this game or not? That doubt should not come. You should be fighting here. Let's see. Bishop h3 check also on the cards, but then oh, he goes a6. A6. He's played his pawn to a6. What's his plan to knight c7? It's a difficult move, no, to consider knight c7 because c6 pawn is hanging. But according to the engines, this is the best move. If you take on c6, then I take on a6, and then my threat is to take on c5 and take on d6. So a6 is a very interesting move. And maybe, you know, guys, in that variation which we were looking at, bd5, cd5, rook b4, d4, Vidit may want to put his rook on b7 with the defense of the pawn. That's why he played a6. So now this knight c7 move, if Fear finds, then really he's in great form, great shape, if he finds knight c7 here. If he doesn't find knight c7, maybe Vidit's chances of winning this game are very high. But if he finds knight c7, then Vidit is going to kind of struggle. Okay. Bishop c6 was played by Gukesh here, not knight. He was like, okay, I'm blocking with the bishop. Rook d8. Okay. Rook d8. Why not rook c8? Maybe just rook b3 and then rook b6, because you can't take twice. There is rook b8 mate almost. I mean, you'll have to give up the knight. Okay, what's up with Padmini? Padmini plays queen b6. Wow. Padmini back in the game, guys. Padmini back. So Padmini around equalish position. Maybe Sara slightly better after c4. But much more improvement than what it started with. Gukesh, on the other hand, has a great position, by the way. Great position here after rook c3. And he can be fighting for a win and equalizing the score. With it, on the other hand, after a6, Fear take. And you know, I'm seeing this in Fear always, that whenever the position is coming to a situation where there's a critical move, he takes his time. He takes his time. And that's a sign of a very good player, because he understands that now is something is necessary to think. By the way, what is the point? I mean, let's say, I was just thinking, bishop h3 kaisa move hai? You have to go back, right? Because f5, there is e4. Attacks the knight and attacks the pawn. So you had to go back, but I think Vidit did not see any improvement in his position. So here, by the way, after a6, oh, bishop b1 has been played. Ah, blunder. It's a bad move. As we told, yeah, it was a difficult moment for Pierre to find knight c7. And now, can Vidit... Okay, couple of moves here. One is rook c1 is a strong idea. But rook c1, bishop a2 and take here? What's the point? Like, bishop a2 attacking this pawn. He wants to take on here, take here. And then, oh, knight b7. That was Vidit's brilliant concept with a6. And now b4 is hanging. c6, c7 is coming. My God, that was the thing that Vidit had come up with. So now, oh, this is great. Because when you take here attacks the rook. So I can even start with this, right? Take here, cd, rook c1. Abhi isko attack karte hai. If he goes back, then I play knight b7, and then I'm winning this. Isn't this also a viable way to play? Because I'm also attacking your rook. You play rook d8, I chop this off. Yeah, it's a very interesting, I think. But the game, you know, guys, the motifs are not very easy somehow. There, knight b7, you have to put. The rook comes from here. Bishop takes d5 at the right moment. It's all very jumbled up. Only 4 minutes left for Vidit. Meanwhile, what's Gukesh doing? Gukesh has found the best move. Rook ac3. I would say even Gukesh, you know, just the fact that you have put Dubov in so much pressure in a must-win game itself is commendable. Tremendous job by the youngster. such a world class player here you're facing. You're putting him under pressure, but Gukesh is like, no. What world class and all? I have to win. My only focus is how to win. King g7. And now bishop b5. Pull out the bishop. Exchange on the c file. Get this. And guys, remember what we had spoken of. If you play rook c8 and if all the four rooks come off the board, we had mentioned that this was winning position. You just go knight c6 and win the a5 pawn. That is just over. So that is not a good idea. Bishop b5. I'm sure Gukesh is going to play bishop b5. Padmini Raut, after playing queen b6, your c4 was found by Sara Khadem. So bd4 check was played by Padmini. King h1, knight f6, knight takes b7, queen b7. Padmini is even ready to give up a pawn here. You know, if you take here cb, ab, bishop b5, she's like, okay, fine, doesn't matter. My knight jumps to g4. Knight e3 is a threat. But Sara Khadem is like so careful here. She goes bishop c3 and she's like, I want to get rid of this strong bishop on d4. Very good move. Very good move. She's not getting tempted by an extra pawn. Excellent. Excellent play. Meanwhile, Gukesh did play bishop b5. Gukesh has played bishop b5 here and has good chances. And also Vidit, what did he do? Vidit's game, Vidit, after bishop b1, has played bishop h3 check, king e7. Okay. Oh, and he finds a brilliant move, bishop f5. Wow, what a move by Vidit. What a move. Guys, bishop f5. Man, I didn't think of this. Okay, the thing is, if you take knight takes, now king e6, there is knight g7, you lose a pawn. So king f7, you try to save it. And now you launch an attack with your rook on the what a concept, man. g7 is hanging. If you play g6, rook takes h7. King here, then rook g7, and then rook g6. Oh my god, what a brilliant move by Vidit Gujarati. Bishop f5. And you don't even have time for rook d6 because cd6 comes with a check. And if you now take f5, knight f5. Oh, epic. Epic. Vidit has risen to the occasion. And is now like bishop f5, knight f5, king f7 has happened. I'm sure he's going to find rook here. Okay, rook h7 is also tempting to take. But rook cg4 is just killer move. Okay, rook h7 also. Also good. This knight still remains there as a spectator, as a beautiful spectator on the center. But somehow this where I thought the rook could get misplaced has worked out beautifully. You know the entire concept. He's taken on h7. He didn't go rook g4. Second best move was rook h7, but still totally better. Okay, there is one thing which Vidit has to be careful about. King g6. Oh my god, look at this, guys. If you go here rook g8, then there is rook g4, and then you anyway lose this pawn. So king g6 was the only move. Attacking here and here, I'm sure Vidit has spotted rook takes g7, king takes f5, and now e4. This is a key move where you fork two pieces. That has happened. e4, king e6 also has taken place on the board. Now e takes d5, also the knight is taken. Do you take with the rook? Then this pawn is anyway lost. You take with the c pawn. I think that's the most important move. Yeah, you hit the rook. But now, after rook c1, the point is, which Vidit will play, a7 is weak, c pawn is a passer, and if you count the pawns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 pawns versus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So Vidit is a pawn up, has a strong passer here, and also a7 weakness. So all cards in his favor. All cards in his favor here. Oh, he didn't go rook c1, he went rook h4. He played his rook to h4. Maybe he wants to double this side. But now, if this pawn moves forward, anyway, he went rook dc8. And now, can Vidit just snatch this pawn? Rook endgames are always very tricky. I hope that Vidit doesn't mess this up, but meanwhile, after bishop b5, rook b7 was played by Dubois, rook c6, rook db8, and rook c8. Okay. Gukesh wants to get one pair of rooks off the board, so he went rook c8. And what's up with Padmini here? Padmini, Amruta, welcome back.
Welcome.
There is a lot of action that is happening, but
yes,
you will have to just
sure.
immerse yourself
no
into
problem,
this.
No
Queen h3, knight e8, g4. Padmini's position is roundabout even. She's fought back from an inferior position like amazingly well. Gukesh, on the other hand, after rook c8 is better. But maybe, I'm not sure if he's able to convert this or not, but we'll see. He's put Dubo
yeah,
under immense
even
pressure.
Yeah, but put Dubo under pressure until this point.
This is nothing. This is
wow.
nothing. He had much more
yeah.
pressure.
Okay.
And Vidit, meanwhile, is winning totally here. So that means Vidit has great chances of moving to the next round. He just has to be careful here. He's thinking, Amruta, whether he should take the a7 pawn here. Should he do something
yeah.
else?
Because if he takes a7, rook takes c5, he will have to calculate what happens.
Yes.
And then rook. Okay. But is it a good idea to take on a7, Sagar? Or rook h7 sounds more interesting?
Yeah, just take on a7. Maybe that's fine.
Oh, 55 seconds. And pure at 6 minutes. That's quite a lot.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Time can play a big role here.
Yeah, rook b7
he went. Rook b7. And now rook a8. Good move by Fear.
But now rook h7, then rook.
But Amruta, rook h7.
Rook
now
c5.
With the exchange of one pair of rooks,
mm-hmm.
this is not 100% clear whether this is winning or not.
It's complicated. And if you support with rook b5, is that okay?
Maybe what?
With the idea of rook b4. So rook b5.
Ah, you want to play rook b5.
Yeah.
But then d4.
King e2?
Yeah, and then king d5. So the king.
Complicated.
I think with it playing rook b7 has made the position complicated. He goes rook h, h7. And now Fear must take on c5. No other move, yeah.
So he takes on c5, then give rook e7 check maybe, or take
no,
on
but
b4.
Here the king can come out.
You are helping him, yeah?
Yeah.
So you have to take on a7, right? Not even b4. Like for rook c5?
Yeah. Like notice rook c5, rook a7, rook a7, rook a7. And then, I
rook
don't know.
C3,
maybe rook consider. C1 check. Oh, but you know, Amruta, the point is not to take first. First, give a check. And based on where the king goes,
king e2.
You can decide. If king e2, you can go rook c8 and keep the rooks
oh,
on the
rook
board.
C2 check
and then
the white king is in danger. Yeah?
Would be dangerous. So here rook h7.
Surely complicated. It's surely complicated.
Yeah, Fear is now thinking here. What about Gukesh? Has he? Oh, look at Dubo has got his rook activated. So king f2, knight a6, bishop d5. Oh, he's won a pawn though. Amruta, he's won a pawn. That's something, no?
Yes. But bishop e4 now, if bishop e4, fe4, that should be okay with the central pawns very
yeah,
strong for white.
This is fine.
Will not take.
But I think rook a1 will come to attack here.
Rook b2 check, king g3, and then maybe he'll go rook a2.
Check.
King
maybe
g3.
King g3, yeah.
Yeah, but after rook a2, you're right, Sagar. How to defend a4 pawn? Bishop c6, knight c6, knight c6, rook a4, knight e7. How is that endgame there?
King e1, yeah. Now it's
wasn't king g3 the only plan because now h3 is also weak.
So maybe Dubois has got things under control here.
Oh, Padmini's game.
Padmini's game
very
complicated. So complicated, you know, Amruta. The black king looks almost like it's going to get mated, but she's taken on f5 and rook f5. Oh, blunder, rook
yeah.
f5, rook f5.
Oh, bishop f is not possible, queen h6.
Yes.
Such a simple blunder. Wow, what a chance.
Oh my god, sorry guys. I blundered. Sorry.
Alright, that was
quick. Oh, rook g1. She thinks that there is a mate here. But now Padmini can go queen f8. I think she's missed queen f8. That's the only
Queen of
move.
it, then
Queen
Queen
F8,
of
Queen
it,
F8, Rook
Rook of
F8.
it, and she
And
saves
Padmini will
the.
win. Padmini will win.
This is amazing. What a news we have. What a news.
No, but wait, will she find it? 1 minute 38 seconds.
You know, Sagar, it's a forced idea, so she will find it. How else do you save the
Yeah.
G7 mate?
No, of course. It's the only
Rook
move.
A7, then Rook G8 is a mate. Queen
Yeah.
E7, then Bishop
Queen
F5.
E5 is another move, but then you lose Bishop F5.
And for Queen F8, Queen F8, Rook F8. Okay, for Queen F8, is there anything else for
No,
White?
no, no.
Yeah,
This then it's
he'll keep his
Oh,
queens.
Queen
Queen H.
F8. Is there Rook G8?
Queen G8, Rook
Queen
G8, Rook
G8?
G8. Yeah, but that she will have to go for.
But that is
No
winning. That
choice.
is winning because Rook G8, Queen G8, Bishop G8, Rook G8, and there is Rook F1 mate here.
Oh, right. I was thinking of D6, but Rook F1 is coming. You can't do anything. And if Queen H3, Rook
Okay, let me
F2.
go quickly to Vidit's game. And after Rook H7,
He's played Rook
oh, he
C6.
played Rook C6. Maybe not the best move. That would give Vidit a great winning
Yeah, because
chance.
Rook A7
G4,
simple. No? Okay, G4.
D4.
Wow, look at the move G4. His threat was Rook E7
Mate,
mate.
mate ka
So
tha na.
D4 was
And
forced.
now he's again threatening
No,
mate. Rook
exactly.
E8.
And
Vidit
now take A7.
is like pawn one kisko chahiye. I want to go after your king.
Yeah, now take A7.
Guys, G4 was to take away this square, and you
Beautiful
see
move.
this was a mate here. So he took on A7, Rook C5. Once again, Vidit in a dominating position here, but he has only 20 seconds.
Which is enough for this position? Not no.
I don't know.
Okay, let's jump to Padmini's position because did she play Rook G8 or
Okay,
not?
Vidit is winning, right?
Yes.
What about Gukesh? Very quickly here. Gukesh position is equal according to the engines, but still I think Dubo has to be careful. Dubo has to be careful. Meanwhile, after Queen F8, Sara Khadam is down to 13 seconds. She plays Queen H3.
Oh, now just save your rook. Rook G8 is not even a threat there. Maybe Rook F3.
Rook F3. Ha. Rook F3 is good. Rook F3. But Padmini nerves of steel. Okay, guys, we are back. We are back. We are back. Very sorry for that small interruption there. I think we are back. D6 has been played. Sorry. D6. Okay, Padmini winning here. What about Vidit? Rook AB7. And fear thinking. Refresh,
Can
refresh, refresh, refresh.
fear go rook a5 and then try for d3 d2? Would that seem a little intimidating for 20 seconds?
Yeah, but Rook A5 just A7 with the idea of Rook B8.
Yeah, but rook a5 a7 d3 rook
Rook B8.
b8 rook e7. Ah, then takes takes a8
Yeah,
takes
yeah.
takes d8.
One minute 53 second 50 seconds for fear. He's thinking. He knows he's in trouble. Gukesh here has got his king up to F3. Gukesh has some
Wow, I thought
choices.
he will fall for some drawing mechanism with the rook and
No,
knight
no, no. King
perpetual.
G3, King G3. He's still there. He's still there.
Amazing.
Gukesh is hanging
Fighting,
in. You
fighting.
know, he's there that I want to win. I want to beat Dubo somehow.
He's
Guys,
angry now.
Gukesh, even if he, you know, draws or loses this, just kudos to his fighting spirit. Oh, Rook F6. What
What
a
blunder? Kissing? What?
Queen B2 is just over because there is Rook G8 coming in.
No,
Padmini was
but queen.
totally with Amrita here. It was not so simple. She had to play a move like B3 or Queen F6, something of that sort. She went Rook F6, which looks very simple, but now Queen
But queen B2,
B2.
queen E7, I didn't
Oh,
get it.
she took Queen E4. Mistake. She
Too
took
many blunders happening
and
here.
Queen E7. Now Padmini is back. Now Padmini is back.
Oh my god. Sir, queen B2 was also very tough
Yeah,
because
it was
what
tough.
I didn't understand was queen E7 anyway.
Yeah, maybe.
And rook G8 check king H7. Oh my god, this is
Rook G6,
so
but now you can
horrible.
take, right? Queen G6.
Sagar,
Yeah.
you know Queen B2?
What? She got mated. Oh! Padmini got mated.
Rook D7 she took.
She got checkmated.
Bap re!
Unbelievable.
So sad for her, so disheartening. She would have, like, she really had it in her bag.
Oh, it's such
She was
unfortunate. She was winning. She's in a winning position. She blundered mate in one.
dead winning. Did she play when she had 1 second or something, Sagar?
Yeah, something like she had very little time. She had to take and play queen g7 and she was better, clearly better. But she played rook takes d7 and got checkmated in one move. How unfortunate can that be?
Oh no.
Whew.
Happens.
Yeah, it happens, but it's a lot of pressure.
And this game towards the end, it was very difficult to calculate all the mating patterns all the time for both sides.
Oh, look at Gukesh's king in trouble. At g4 is a checkmate.
So you have to take, then g4 is a checkmate.
Yeah, I think.
What do you do now?
You have to play knight f6, king f6, hg5 check, then gf5. But then it's like you've given up your knight. So in the end, things not working out. But meanwhile, Vidit has won.
Oh, Vidit won.
Vidit has won the game.
Brilliant, but it ended very soon.
Ah, Vidit. What happened is, after rook c5, rook b7, d3 was played here. And Vidit here played check, king d5, check, king, and resigns because king e4, rook b4, mate. Like king f3, there is rook d3, mate.
Oh, it's a mate.
Yeah.
Mate.
He hunted the king. And guys, Vidit Gujarati has moved on to round number 3 here. And he is going to face Adipan next. What a victory. So let's quickly move to Gukesh's game. That's the only game that's going on.
Okay. First of all, Gukesh, like Dubov will try to beat Gukesh, right? If he gets a possibility.
So but Amrita, it may not be so simple for Dubov to win because he's down too many pawns.
Yeah, king g5, gh5, king h5. Actually, white can win the a5 pawn also and e7 also. So still, with the three central pawns, there could be some ideas.
Yeah.
Because the knight is very far away. The only problem is black, white king will get mated.
Hmm. King g5. And
do
now
you give check first?
Yeah, we can give rook c5 check and then take gh5 and then a5 is also hanging.
But do you want to take that? Or I thought e7, if you take, you have passer. E passer.
Are either mate?
Maybe
no,
after gh5. Okay, rook c5. As many rook pawns on the board, that's better.
The problem is, if you go king g6, there is gh5 and rook a5. If you go king h6, there is rook h5 and rook a5.
So,
you have to go
two
king
pawns.
f6. Yeah, you have to go king f6.
And then rook h5 or gh5.
Then I can play gh5. But then he has rook g5 to prevent that.
Hmm. So, for king f6, you will have to play rook h5.
On one hand, we had a happy news of Vidit qualifying. On another hand, we had a very, very kind of depressing news because Padmini, who was like sure to win almost, mm-hmm. I mean very close, she blundered mate in one. Now Gukesh is still fighting here, and guys, if he takes on h5 and then takes on a5, I think there is some hope still there because he will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pawns and only one pawn to black.
So why would Dubov go king h6 and allow rook h5 with the check?
He wants rook e2 and winning this pawn.
Ah, he feels that those are that is a better chance for a draw.
Yeah, look at this, Amrita. Rook e2, king here.
Okay,
king
rook takes c3.
And then rook g2 check.
Rook g2, king f4.
King f4, knight d3 check.
Okay, so he first gives a check. But then king g5, you have to give a check.
Check, check. Yeah, Gukesh gains some time with some checks.
Only 17 seconds.
It's such a, and he may not even take here, Amrita, because taking means allows that. So he goes rook c, and then now if king f4, knight d3 check. Now you don't have this move. If you come king f3, knight e1, it's a drawing mechanism. Oh, and now he's coming here. So now Gukesh, in order to win here, has to find some way out, like maybe king h4, but.
But rook e3 then?
Yeah, rook e3 with the idea of ng2 mate.
No, you can't do that. Maybe practically this would end in a draw. Oh no, he plays e5, allows rook e3 check.
Well, this is that situation, no, Amrita, where in a must win, you have to go all out, and now he's landing in a tough position, like king g5. But really, tremendous fight, guys, by Gukesh. And
But Sagar, even such a decision, because he had a draw, right? He had a perpetual there.
Yeah.
So he went for a fight here.
Well, of
Even
course, he
taking the
doesn't.
bad position, he can get rating with a
No,
player like
it's
Dubois.
just rapid, no? So.
Ah.
So classical rating won't be affected. I don't know if knockout games are anyway rated in like rapid rating also, is it affected or not? Maybe not. Yeah, now just knight f3 check and win the d4 pawn. It's king g5.
Wow, he had a great fight, right?
Yeah, I mean guys, just Gukesh OP, really, he has played so well. He has played so well. He's won so many hearts. You guys know how good Dubov is. To make him, struggle so hard, even in the last game, to give him such a tough fight, it speaks
Absolutely.
volumes of this young boy's talent. And I'm sure that he's going to take back such a rich experience from this event.
I would agree with you.
And for Vidit, I mean Amruta, what a equal game match it was, like with fear.
And then finally, with White, he was able to break
Yeah,
through. Yeah, that.
he broke through there. Oh, by the way, now he took. Oh, Gukesh is back in the game. There was King F4, which was winning for Black, but Knight D4, Rook E7. I mean,
I mean, not winning, but
it's
okay, this is
perfect.
already a draw at least.
Yeah.
But if
I think
Mo
Gukesh.
goes wrong, then with the rook pawn. Okay,
Beautiful.
rook
Amruta,
a7,
look
knight
at the
c6.
chat. Everyone in the chat is
Okay.
like Gukesh OP.
Yeah.
So nice.
In fact, Sagar, these three games, when all three in a way had to win, I mean, of course, Vidit could still be okay with the draw, but other both had to strike back. Padmini was also
Padmini
winning.
played a typical game of hers where she took a minus position. Dheere, 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 she played, kept fighting out draw here, no 96. Yeah, Dubo has qualified to the next round. Great fight by Gukesh, but well played Dubo. He didn't let the youngster prevail, which could have happened. He was not too far
Almost,
away.
almost. Yeah.
And guys, Padmini Raut, who, Amruta, if I just show you this game, you will realize, like, here, main move in Grunfeld is c5, right? But Padmini went castles. She said, "I'll take an inferior position. I won't even strike the center. Let Black, like d5, get her knight to d2, give her a passed pawn." Everything she did, but then slowly she went first e4, then she got attacked here. Then she played a6 and b5,
Wow.
queen b6, bishop d4, knight f6, threatening knight g4, knight e3. So take, take. Sara played very well with bishop c3. Take. B4, queen e3, queen b6, and now this knight d6 take. Somehow,
What a
like,
tremendous game.
it was a great
Because the
fight.
knight is very strong, the bishop is very strong. It's not like any one of the minor pieces is just good or
Yes,
something.
and now she
Both
took on f5.
the kings are weak. Knight f5,
And
trying to lose. Ah,
you
that's
had to
time.
play queen g5 to keep the balance, but
Rook
she
f5
took.
was a blunder, correct.
And now Padmini is winning. Queen f8, she found. She also found Rook F3, and
But
now,
continuous, accurate defense moves she had to make.
yeah, H6 was okay still. D6, Rook D8 was fine. D7, and now the move which you were saying, like, here Queen F6. If she had found, though, she would have won.
Yeah, is Queen f6 winning? For sure,
I mean, the
Queen.
main thing is, Amruta,
Because Queen
it's
f6.
also difficult to even assess this because check
Yeah, okay.
takes takes, and you feel like, oh, you'll make a
Yeah,
queen. But the
exactly.
point is, you will get checkmated here. Oops, sorry,
Rook
not Rook F1.
f1.
Rook F1, King here, and Queen F3 mate.
Ah, that's why
So,
there is no time for Queen.
actually, I mean, what looks really winning according to the engine is not so trivial, of course. But after her move D7, Rook F6, Queen B2 was winning,
Yeah,
and
this
you
was tough.
said,
You know, here you had, if you play King H, Queen e7,
yeah.
Rook g8 check.
No, not Rook G8, Rook
Why not? Because
G6.
I thought Rook g8,
But Rook G8, Bishop G8,
Bishop
King
g8,
G8.
King g8.
But here
Okay.
Rook G6, and you win this.
Rook
Like Rook
f8,
F8,
then you take and what?
Queen E5.
So just wait. Yeah, black is in a zugzwang and King
Yeah.
h7 now.
Take.
Rook f6.
Yeah, it's tough. Bishop F5 and win this queen.
Oh, huh.
It's
long
not easy.
combination.
It's not easy.
Long combination.
And then Amrutha, she went wrong. Queen e7, rook g6. And now actually if Padmini would have just taken this take and queen g7 defending this pawn, she's now better. Now she can just breathe a little, you know, play king at queen f6,
queen
f1
check
king
also, maybe gain some time if she wants to.
And guys, what she did here was that she just played rook d7. And
this would be a blind side. Like, I mean, come on, she can find this, but so much pressure and just 2-3 seconds in hand, that would be tough.
Yeah, just updating the scores here for everyone.
But
so that
great fight by Padmini also. So guys, Padmini OP for sure. This was a great game. And she
everyone
was playing
played
a higher rated opponent here, a very strong player, Sara Khadim. So
no, I think all Indians played beautifully, Amrutha. Guys, we came here with 12 players, correct? And now we are going, we have after round 2, 6 players left.
Okay.
One will definitely be eliminated in the next round.
Two Indians.
Because Adiban and Vidit playing each other. But it's also good news because one will definitely go to round 4. There will be no.
Yeah.
Also, I think next round will be very exciting, guys. So we have Adiban Vidit. And also
Nihal versus Andrikin, Hare Krishna versus Lupulescu.
Yeah, I'll just bring up these pictures so that everyone can see it. Next round, we have Hare Krishna Lupulescu, Nihal versus Andrekin, Pragnananda versus Krasenkov, Harika versus Gunina, and Vidit versus Adiban. Shall we do a small poll?
Yeah, sure.
Maybe tomorrow. I wanted to ask people about Vidit and Adiban, but it's so difficult, guys.
Yeah, maybe
we like both of them so much, and now we have to choose between the two. We have Digital Human who says, Sagar, I'm a bit confused why Vidit would be paired against Adiban. Isn't this supposed to be played in teams? No, it's not team event. It's just that we are portraying the Indian team as one unit, but it's an individual event. So there is, like every day in our roundup, I mentioned like, oh, totally we scored this, totally we scored that. So it's not a team event. It's an individual event and it's based on ratings. The pairings are done based on ratings. Okay, guys, so we'll see you tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. At night, we will have the commentary of the No Castling Chess, Amrutha.
Yeah.
Right? Is that true?
Yes.
And right now, Anand versus Kramnik's game is still in progress. We have the other stream that is going on, so you can
today
already go there.
Create any issues for your stream, I hope.
Yes, no issues. Guys, before ending the stream, I would like to ask you, did you guys enjoy? Did you enjoy today?
Poll.
People are saying create poll for Vidit and Adiban. Okay, let's see. Who do you think will win? Vidit Adiban. Very tough. Want to know your thoughts? It's actually frustrated CA says FIDE should improve fan interaction through FPL means. Okay, maybe like football Premier League. I made a poll here, so you can actually I think people can't see it, right, Amrutha? Because this is pinned. I'll unpin. The sad part about this event is that only one can go through. There is no way both can qualify. So that's the thing about this event. Oh, AG is playing tomorrow. He will play Abdu Satarov Nodirbek. That is his opponent.
Today, what happened with Murzin's game?
He lost.
And Sindara versus Ali Reza, any result?
I'll check,
idea?
I'll check, I'll let you know.
No, the poll is not coming
Poll is working. I don't know.
there. No, I don't think so because you'll have to remove that and then get
I don't
it.
know. But okay, let's leave that for another time. Yeah, so
So Alireza versus ऊपर 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 हाँ
draw.
so they
Still a draw.
they are
They are going in the
going
next stage. They are going to the next stage. Wow. Okay, guys, we'll call it a night. And also, guys, last few packs left of premium pack of Vedika's chocolates. If you want to get them, please do check out in the description. There is the link. The regular pack is over. So if you would like to have them, please do check this out. You can get this delivered to your homes. It's very nice. And also, today, Amruta, we started off with 715,900 approximately, and we have had around 400 more people who have subscribed. So thank you all for subscribing. If you enjoy the commentary, please do subscribe to
Oh,
Chess Base
very
India.
nice.
Simple guys, this is Sagar. Please cover Anish's games also. He has many fans here and he has been a very good friend of this channel. Of course, we have been covering his games yesterday as well. He won, and we will do so from tomorrow as well. So I was also planning to make a recap video on his both the victories, which was very nicely done by him.
Okay, I think we are done for
Oh,
today.
poll is working, Amruta.
Oh, poll is working.
69% for Vidit, that's what they say. 69 for Vidit, 31. There are around 3,500 votes.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Let's see how this goes. Tomorrow, I mean, we clearly would want the best player to win, whatever happens.
No,
We'll
we
see.
clearly want a player who plays the best during that time.
Yeah,
That's all.
that's what I
Yeah.
meant by best player. So, whoever plays the best chess on that given day. But once again, guys, to end this stream, Padmini OP, Vidit OP, and Gukesh OP, all three of them fought truly like lions, as you can see here, all three of them. And Vidit makes it to the next round. Padmini and Gukesh are eliminated. But great learning experience for both. Take care. Bye bye. See you.